They'll need at least one other point. If Washington beats the Islanders, then they move into a tie for first place, and both teams with two games left in the regular season. So coming up, big game, the Islanders and the Capitals, and Denis Potvin tonight, and we'll be reviewing his career.
Pittsburgh, three ahead of New Jersey in the fight for that fourth and final playoff spot. A big win for the Blue Shirts, their first, in fact, in Chicago in 5 years. At the stadium, first period, Rangers break a one-all tie. Lucien Deblois centers for Don Maloney. He flips the puck over Darren Pang's shoulder, and it is 2-1. Later, the Rangers increase that lead to 3-1. Kelly Kissio redirects Brian Leetch's slap shot past Pang. The Rangers hold on and win 4-3. Maloney, his 11th goal of the season, one assist. What a victory that was for the Rangers. Elsewhere last night, Edmonton defeated Minnesota 6-3. Fuhr sets that record for the most appearances by a goalie in a season. And Calgary lost to the Los Angeles Kings 9-7. Luke Robitaille, 2 goals and 4 assists. Tonight, 5 of the Patrick Division's 6 teams are on the ice. Only the Rangers are resting. You'll see the Islanders collide with the Capitals here on Sports Channel. Right now on Sports Channel Plus, the Devils are battling the Pittsburgh Penguins down at the Igloo. Ice conditions are bad in the early going. There's no score in the first period. We'll keep you posted on this one with highlights throughout tonight's game. Montreal and Quebec and Philadelphia also playing tonight. There's no score there in the first period. In the Adams Division, Montreal and Boston, the first and second place teams are meeting, no score in the first, and Hartford playing Buffalo. The Whalers secured that 4th spot in the playoffs. Buffalo is 3rd, no score there in the first. One guy you'll want to keep an eye on for the Islanders tonight is rookie Jeff Norton. The Olympian scored the game winner over the Flyers Tuesday night. Stan Fischler spoke with him after the game.
Jeff, you were thrust into a pressure cooker situation here coming off the Olympics, and you've responded admirably. Are you feeling now less of the tension than you did when you came here?
Yeah, I feel a lot. You know, the team has really helped out. I mean, they've given me a lot of support coming in, and I was a little worried coming in this late in the year. And so, I was coming off a big high from the Olympics, but, you know, this has been my dream for a long time, and, you know, I feel comfortable here. I'm glad to be here, and, you know, it's great hockey, and, I have a great supporting cast around here, and, you know, everything's going as good as I can expect it to go.
Jeff Norton. This was billed as a rebuilding year for the Islanders, but here they are in first place with 3 games to go. We asked Coach Terry Simpson if he's satisfied with the club's status.
Around here, you're expected to win the Stanley Cup every year, never mind make the playoffs, so I don't know how you view that, but I think that in a rebuilding situation such as we say we're in, I guess that's important. I think that there's some good things about our team. I think as you watch it over a 2-year span, I think some players are emerging, but we're still a long ways from out of the woods yet. I mean, a lot of guys have to be proven in pressure situations and key playoff games and so on and so forth. So I think we're coming along, but we have a long ways to go.
As we follow the race to the wire, it's time to start thinking about the best individual performers in the National Hockey League as the league considers the various awards to be delivered. Jiggs and Eddie are standing by at the Coliseum. Any thoughts on those individual awards, gentlemen?
Yeah, we've got quite a few thoughts. Number one, I guess, Lee, beginning with, we wish we had a vote. We do vote for the coach of the year as broadcasters, but none of the others. If we did, let's begin with the most valuable player, the Hart Trophy Award. There's a lot of arguments about this one, but I'm going to give my vote to Grant Fuhr of the Edmonton Oilers. 40th victory last season. The criteria for winning the most valuable player is the most valuable player on his team. And in my opinion, Edmonton wouldn't even be in second place if it weren't for Grant Fuhr. There hasn't been a goaltender win the MVP award since 1962 when Jacques Plante, the late Jacques Plante, won it. I'm giving it to Grant Fuhr. How about you?
No, I'm not giving it to Grant Fuhr. I'm going to go with the logical choice because I think he deserves it more than Grant Fuhr. None other than Mario Lemieux. Now, there's a lot of backups to that, but Mario Lemieux has done what he's expected to do, lead the Pittsburgh Penguins. Now, if they don't make the playoffs, so what? He's still worth the price of admission in every city in this league. And to me, he's done a lot, not only for the league, but he's done it for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Where would they be without Mario Lemieux? And then you've got Yzerman, and you've got, how about Pat LaFontaine, and how about Dennis Savard? But I've got to go with Lemieux. How about you, Stan?
Well, I'm going with the dipsy doodle dandy, Denny Savard of the Blackhawks. I just feel that he is the entire team right there. I don't feel they have the goaltending. I don't feel they have any defense, and I just don't think they have much of anything besides Denny. He's my man. I'll take him.
Did he say Savard?
Yeah.
I think so. Okay, here's the way it tallies up then. We've got votes for Grant Fuhr, for Mario Lemieux, and for Denny Savard. So we're all split on that one. For the Norris Trophy, the best defenseman in the league. I think there really should be two trophies here. The best offensive defenseman and the best defensive defenseman. Taking it purely from what the trophy is, for the best defenseman, Scott Stevens of the Washington Capitals.
You're trying to keep it in the family again, Jiggs, and I know it. Well, I like Scott Stevens. I've been a big fan of his for a long time, but I'm going to go with Ray Bourque. I don't think the Boston Bruins would be that good without Ray Bourque. He's not only a good defenseman, but he's a good offensive defenseman. He does a lot. He leads the team in so many categories, and he leads the league in so many categories. Ray Bourque.
Who's your pick? For you, Salming Stan?
No, as president of the Charlie Bourgeois Fan Club, I was going to give it to Charlie, but he's been benched by the Whalers. I'm giving it to Scott Stevens. I think he does everything now. Tough, scores points. He's my man.
All right, I agree, but I don't think he'll win it. They'll probably go with the offensive numbers. But Stevens gets two votes here. Eddie going with Ray Bourque of the Boston Bruins. This one should be unanimous. The Rookie of the Year, winner of the Calder Trophy, the best first-year player in the league. The numbers tell it all. Joe Nieuwendyk of the Calgary Flames, 51 goals, 41 assists. You don't top that.
I want Darren Pang because I can't spell Nieuwendyk either. I know. I mean, yes, it's as convincing as when Ronald Reagan won his last election. Joe Nieuwendyk, he's got it all, he's done it all, and you can't argue, Stan.
Yeah, I don't even know why you guys bothered to ask me. I mean, this has got to be unanimous. There's nobody close. Nieuwendyk for me, too.
Nieuwendyk across the board. 1, 2, 3. Westfall, McDonald, and Fischler all going for the kid with the Calgary Flames. Now, the one vote that we as broadcasters do have is for the Coach of the Year in the National Hockey League. Jacques Demers was the winner last year. He took the Detroit Red Wings from 40 points to 78. He's taken them from 78 to 91 this year, and he's getting my vote again as NHL Coach of the Year. I'm going to give my second place vote to Jerry Simpson of the Islanders, but number one to Jacques Demers.
We finally agree, Jakes. I agree. Jacques Demers has been dynamic. He's been great. He's led his team in so many ways. But I can't forget about honorable mention to Terry Crisp for one, Ted Sater of the Buffalo Sabres for another.
Crisp inherited a team with 95 points.
Yes,
and he got a lot of toys to play with.
But what if they fell apart? Stan,
who do you like?
I agree with you again. Jacques Demers, you said it all. That's all I have to say.
We have to say happy birthday, Stan, by the way. You're our Rookie of the Year. But Demers gets all three votes for the Adams Trophy as Coach of the Year from this broadcast group. There are some others, of course. We're not going to get into those tonight. But you look back at it, it'll be chosen by the writers because they have a financial agreement with the National Hockey League. That'll do it for Hockey Tonight on Sports Channel. When we come back on Denny Potvin Night, his final game of the regular season, we'll be underway with the Islander pregame show.
The people who make the best German beer are happy to announce the best German light beer. Drybeck's Light from Beck's. 96 calories, 100% German.
You're watching Sports Channel, the official channel of the New York fan.
You know, you were right about Marsh's. What a terrific selection.
I told you. Isn't that style a little flashy for you, Dad?
Come on, don't be so conservative.
That's okay. I'll take a nice gray pinstripe any day.
So what else does this place have?
You name it, Marsh's has it. Everything from socks to sportswear.
What do you think of the old man now?
Impressive, Dad. Very impressive.
Marsh's. Something for everyone.
My business required a sophisticated, custom-designed alarm and closed-circuit television system.
My business needed a reliable, unobtrusive alarm system without conspicuous wires.
Our home needed the same high-level fire and burglar protection as our businesses.
Our alarm specialist custom designed the right system.
At the right price.
For our businesses as well as our home.
And backed by 24-hour service.
Waymar protects thousands of Long Island families and businesses 24 hours a day. Let Waymar end crime for you. Dial END-CRIME.
Get on board for a Subway Series summer here on Sports Channel, because Sports Channel's got both the Mets and the Yankees in what could be the most exciting New York baseball season ever. Over half the games played by the Mets and Yankees will be available only on Sports Channel, featuring great coverage of Mattingly, Winfield, Strawberry, and Hernandez, all swinging for the pennant. So get on board for a Subway Series summer right here on Sports Channel.
The New York Islander pregame show is brought to you by National Westminster Bank USA, raising the standards of banking. Welcome now to the New York Islanders pregame show. The Islanders and the Washington Capitals tonight, and as I mentioned earlier, prior to the game and following the game, Denis Potvin to be honored, first of all, the Milestone Award for achievements, over 1,000 games, over 1,000 points, and then, of course, the retirement afterward. We don't know exactly what's going to happen, but we do know what has happened during the career, and we know that there's probably 10, 15, 20 places or things you'd rather be doing than here. But what we thought we'd do is reminisce a little bit, and if we can roll some pictures, let's go back to the very beginning of the Denis Potvin career with the New York Islanders. There have been a lot of changes, facial growth to be included.
Yeah, I thought it looked pretty good then, but right now, I wonder.
But that was the style. How about the jowls on the general manager?
I know, there's a lot of difference. And Dad was there, my brother. That was a press conference in 1973. And that was the first team photo.
How about the change in uniform, those laces? They don't make the jerseys that way anymore.
They don't make the skates that way anymore. They don't make the mustaches like that anymore.
Do you remember who that is behind you?
Yeah, it's Dave Hudson. He played with us for a couple of years, then went on to Kansas City, which later became Denver and now New Jersey.
So this would be about the 1973-74 season. Is this
exactly
a new contract or the original?
I think that was a new contract. That was the third, my fourth year into the league. I just won the Norris. I was pretty happy about inking that one.
Still working on that same contract?
No, thank goodness. That's changed, too.
No mustache, hair a little bit longer.
Yeah. Well, the sideburns show you that we're in the mid to late 70s. John Tinelli shows you that he's still concentrating, even though we're not playing.
Yeah. All right. And the face shield.
The shield.
There and gone.
13 years. I went without the shield. I played with it last year, and then I came in this season and played about 50 games without it, and now I have it back on, primarily because I felt that I wasn't doing anything much better without it, so I might as well wear it and be somewhat more protected.
All right, and I think we have a couple of pictures without. Of course, a guy who's been in the Nets just as long as you've played here, too.
Well, you know, that position is not a bad one for me, because as far as Smitty is concerned, I'd have him cover my back anywhere under any circumstance.
All right. And the beard, it's got to be playoff time, and you can tell it's 1980.
1980, I can tell because of the beard. We got the patch on the shoulder showing the Olympics year. As a team, started growing. Most of the guys could grow beards, but there's a couple of guys like Bush Goring who couldn't grow one, Brian Trotche, Mike Bossy. These men of our team couldn't grow whiskers, so some of us had to go ahead.
Of course, 1980 was the first of the Stanley Cups. Here's some more action. This involves the old Colorado Rockies.
Yeah, it does. I guess that I got away with that one. I don't think the referee saw. My stick's doing something. I'm not sure what the end result is, but it doesn't look good.
There have been a lot of those checks. And then, of course, as we mentioned, 80, the first of four Stanley Cup rings. You must have a lot of fond memories.
Well, I don't wear them, and primarily because I hold these as real valuable trophies to me, and I have them vaulted away so that they're safekeeping, and every now and then I take them out and cherish them.
In the Islander dressing room, that locker next year, there won't be a number five hanging there. There will be somebody come along the line to fill that locker.
You know, I look at a young lad like Jeff Norton, and he's probably going to sit there and just not think anything of it at all, just go about his game, and I guess that's the way it should be.
What thoughts are going through your mind now as you prepare for the final home game of the regular season?
Well, I wonder if this is it's the celebration, but the most important thing for me is to win the game. As always, the road to the top is never easy, and for me to enjoy the celebration tonight, a big win would mean a lot.
Well, the memories aren't over yet. There's still the playoffs beyond, but I'm sure I speak for all of the fans when I say thank you for a great, great career.
Thank you. It's been a real pleasure.
All right. Stan Fischler is next, and he also has a video scrapbook of the Islanders number five.
Thank you, Jiggs. Appropriately, it's Chapter 40, Dennis on the Road to the Cup. Game 1 of the 1980 playoff series was probably as most important of all. And here, Denny, early in the period, tries to get the puck to Billy Smith, but he inadvertently knocks it in. And the Flyers went ahead on that one, and Denny told me that he thought it was going to be a crusher, but single-handedly, he wins the game for the team in sudden death overtime. The pass comes from John Tinelli. Denny puts it in. The Islanders win the game. It was the first game of the series, and many people feel it was the most important game for the Islanders because it showed they could win on the road, they could beat the Flyers, and of course they went on and won that series in six games, and Denny was so pivotal, but none more pivotal than that goal in game one. And that was it. Coming up next, Ed Westfall, and his special guest will be Denis Potvin's brother, John Potvin.
You look concerned, Jane.
I feel like everyone takes advantage of me.
How, Jane?
Well, like my bank. I mean, it's my money, right? But they act like they're doing me a big favor.
Banks don't do favors, Jane.
Yeah, they're all alike. Big and personal.
I like my bank.
What, are you crazy?
They guarantee good service.
What bank gives guarantees?
NatWest USA.
You paid $100 for this?
Got that winning feeling, and you know it. That's your winning feeling. There's no stopping you now. That's your showboat feeling. Winning, got that winning feeling.
Get that winning feeling.
That's your showboat.
Tuesday on Sports Channel, it's a Yankees-Nets double play. At 1 in the afternoon, the Bombers collide with Kent Herbeck and the defending world champion Minnesota Twins. And then at 7:30, Willis Reed's Nets shoot it out with Isaiah Thomas and the playoff-bound Detroit Pistons. That's live Yanks and Nets action Tuesday on Sports Channel when the Yankees slug it out with the Twins at 1 and the Nets tangle with the Pistons at 7:30, right here on Sports Channel.
As the Islanders pregame show continues, well, listen, who else but John Potvin to come in and visit with us on such an occasion as his brother's announced retirement and last game here at the Nassau Coliseum. Let's go back, Potsy. We've had fun over the years, and we'll share it with some of our viewers and all of them who are watching. 1973, Terry Crisp goes to the Philadelphia Flyers. You come here, and a lot of people felt that it was kind of a hedge. It was kind of an insurance policy. The world hockey was into its starting stages, and they were afraid Dennis might jump to the world hockey. And what did you think of all that?
Well, a lot of people have a lot of opinions, but as far as I'm concerned, there's no doubt in my mind I never would have been here had it not been for Denis Potvin wanting to come here, and they acquired me for Terry Crisp for that reason, no doubt.
Did you ever talk to Dennis about that or his agent?
Well, I've been thanking him for the last 16 years or so, and I hope to continue to do it for a few more. I'm still doing the radio, you know?
Of course you are. And you could probably have held Tori up maybe for a little bit more had you known then what you know now.
Well, exactly. I mean, I probably could have strung it out for another 7-8 years because Denny kept on playing, and I could have said to Denny, just make sure that you tell him that as long as you're playing, I got to have a place on the bench.
Well, listen, when it comes around to Tori, we've all had a lot of fun with Bill Tori, the general manager, and you've retired as an Islander, I retired as an Islander, and now your brother's retiring as an Islander. And isn't there some kind of a cliche that we've all heard, and I'm sure that Dennis has heard, that Bill used to, you know, kind of echo?
Well, he certainly echoed, a couple of nice things, and when it comes down to, you know, it's at the end of the line, I asked Denny, you know, a couple of times, how did you know that you were at the end of yours? And he gave me his explanations, and that's what he's been explaining in the press for the last couple of months, but Tori just confronted me and asked me to come in the office and said, John, you can keep on playing like that. but not here. So that was more or less, tell me that I've had it? And he says, well, you can keep on playing, but he says, maybe somewhere else. There's no place on this team for you. And I had to make the decision at that time.
Sure.
I want to move somewhere else or stay on Long Island?
No, you made the right decision. We're all glad you did, heaven's sake, with the radio reporting and all the things you've done for Long Island and still continue to do. Tell us now, your brother Bob is here, and he is the oldest. Then you?
Correct. Bobby, we have three brothers. Some people out there might not know, but there's my older brother, Bob, and myself, and then Denny. Denny being the youngest. And
he was Baby Bear.
Baby Bear, and I was Papa Bear.
Yeah.
And Greg Cameron Gunner, our good friend, was Mama Bear.
Yeah.
And Bobby is the oldest in the family. Bobby's 42, I'm 39, and while we're at it, Denny's 34 and a half or whatever.
Brother Bob is a pilot in the Canadian Air Force, is that right?
He was for 8 years a test pilot for the Royal Canadian Air Force, and he's here tonight, my mother's here, so we're going to have a real good time, and I hope the results of the game are the same.
Bob played hockey?
Bob played hockey, but not professionally. He wasn't good enough. He had all the brains in the family.
When did you know Dennis was going to be as good as he turned out to be?
I think I was playing junior hockey. I was playing for the Ottawa 67s, and we had the worst team in the junior A at that time. We had won 6 games in 48. And for the last 10, 12 games of the year, they asked my parents if they would allow Denny to play junior hockey. And Denny at that time was only 13. So I had been quite busy playing my own games. I hadn't seen him play as much as my parents had. And they were telling me how big he was and I knew how big, but how good he was. And Denny at 13 started to play with the Ottawa 67s, and he really did very well. So I knew that his chances were very good at that point.
One quick question: was there ever an envy for you as far as having a brother that was younger and was that good?
And this is quite honest, Ed. And I've often thought maybe there's something wrong with me, but I never ever envied that he was better than I. I've always enjoyed watching him play. We've had some great times together, both when you were playing. You taught us an awful lot, and you helped us and Denny along and myself. I never had any envy, and I was very proud of him, and I'm very proud that he's had such a great career.
Well, we're all very proud of both Pot fans, of course, on tonight when Dennis retires. But with you, John, nice to know you're still around. Please stay around. You make it all much brighter for all of us.
Thanks a lot, Eddie.
Stan Fischler is now going to look inside Denis Potvin and his New York Islanders, along with the Washington Capitals. Stan?
Thank you, Ed. Inside the Capitals, we'll start off with number 32, Dale Hunter. This is his 600th NHL game. Now, you wouldn't know it from watching him on the ice, but they say he is the wittiest man on the Washington Hockey Club. He also gets points. He doesn't have a lot, but he gets big points. He's a clutch hockey player, and right now, I would say he's one of the keys to the Capitals' playoff hopes. Number 32, Dale Hunter. On defense, we've talked a lot about him. Number 3, Scott Stevens, a top candidate for the Norris Trophy. I think maybe Jiggs and Eddie might have been underplaying his chances. I think he has a very good chance. Why? Look at the numbers. He's got almost a point a game playing defense. He's recognized as one of the toughest hitters in the National Hockey League. And if you don't believe me, ask Bob Bassin. He floored Bob with a terrific check the last time they met. Number 3, Scott Stevens, a great hockey player. Let's look inside the New York Islanders. We'll start off with number 8, the ex-Olympian, Jeff Norton. He's got 1-3-4. He's played solid defense since coming to the Islanders. And I'll tell you something, this guy is going to be around a long time. Number 8, Jeff Norton. And finally, and appropriately, inside the Islanders, number 5, Denis Potvin. He has got some records. He could go right into the Hall of Fame now. Listen to these records. Goals, 310. Assists, 743. Points, 1,053. Denis Potvin, going to be in the Hall of Fame. Stay tuned for exciting NHL action. Coming up next, the Washington Capitals and the New York Islanders.
Attention homeowners, if you need money for any reason at all, the Money Store is the place to go. We're where you are, offering fixed rates, second mortgage loans, as low as today's prime rate of 8.5%. Phone the Money Store toll free. One call approval of qualified homeowners. Be sure to ask about the Money Store sponsored MasterCard. No annual fee for the first year. dial 1-800-221-9000.
Automat, auto interiors and accessories.
We can restore the beauty to your car's worn interior or customize for a hot new look.
With replacement carpeting, upholstery, tops, and detailing, Automat can revitalize your car's interior. Choose some quality motoring accessories like custom mats, seat covers, car covers, steering wheels, spoilers, and orthopedically designed Recaro seats for the ultimate in comfort and support. Visit our Hicksville showroom or call today.
After all, you are what you drive.
Did you hear that Woodbury Chrysler Plymouth just got better?
How could that be? They're already the number one Chrysler Plymouth dealer on Long Island. What's made them better?
Da-da-da-da-da-da! Announcing the arrival of the 1988 Chrysler Plymouth.
I suppose you're going to tell me that they're priced low and waiting to see me drive off in one of their new cars?
Absolutely. And now with up to $2,500 cash back or financing as low as 3.8%, you can't lose.
Well, I guess it's true what they say about Woodbury Chrysler Plymouth.
What's that?
The cars, the dealer, an unbeatable combination.
It's a Subway Series summer, only on Sports Channel.
Sports Channel presents New York Islanders Hockey. New York Islanders hockey is brought to you by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. By Mobil Super Unleaded, the high-octane gasoline with a plus. By your New York, New Jersey Subaru dealer. And by Manufacturers Hanover, the financial source worldwide.
Live from the Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum in Uniondale, New York, Sports Channel presents New York Islanders hockey. Tonight, the Islanders take on the Washington Capitals. Hi again, everyone. I'm Jiggs McDonald with Ed Westfall and Stan Fischler. Big night here at the Nassau Coliseum. The Islanders and the Caps, 2 points separated them in the Patriot division. And when it comes down to determining who will go to the playoffs, this game will be most important. The outcome in particular, should they get to a tiebreaker, because as it is right now, 2-2-1 is the season record between these two teams.
And to explain that very quickly, they throw out the first game of the season between the two teams. Actually, the Islanders have 3 wins, 2 losses, and a tie. But for determining first place, they throw out the first game. Islanders cheated again.
Yes, they won that game at the Cap Center in Washington because there were 4 games played in that building this year. That's the one that is wiped out. Then there are other things involving tonight's hockey game. Denis Potvin comes to mind immediately, playing his last regular season home game here. And there he is. He'll be receiving the National Hockey League's Milestone Award in just a few moments, and then, of course, the post-game ceremonies, and we will bring those to you as well. This crowd is really up. You would think that the playoffs had already begun.
Well, at least the finals, if nothing else. Yes, the crowd is really up for all of this, and, of course, rightfully so. First place is at stake for the Islanders. Let's take a look at the standings now so you get a better picture of the Patrick Division. 86 points for the Islanders, 84 for the Washington Capitals. There you have the Philadelphia Flyers at 81. And look at the battle between the Rangers, Pittsburgh, and the New Jersey Devils. We have a report that the Devils were ahead when we went on the air 1-0 over the Pittsburgh Penguins. That game in Pittsburgh, where Pittsburgh has really been tough over the last 8 or 10 games.
And we just have an update. Philadelphia and Quebec are tied 1-1 in the first period of that game. The Islanders and the Capitals will be beginning momentarily. Down on the ice right now, the president of the National Hockey League, Mr. John Ziegler, extending his hand and welcome to Denis Potvin, playing his 1,057th career game tonight, well over 1,000 points, and receiving a milestone award. The criteria, of course, has to do with having accumulated 1,000 points. Skaters receive a milestone for scoring 400 goals. Potvin will not reach that. A totaling 1,000 points he's passed for 1,000 career games. Regular season, and he has surpassed that. A
veteran of 15 seasons, Denis Potvin, receiving a standing ovation as John Ziegler has just presented him with the Milestone Award from the National Hockey League. We'll be ready for the opening face-off between the Islanders and the Capitals after we pause for these messages.
No matter how you drive, drive your engine clean with Mobil Super Unleaded Gasoline. Its high-octane detergent formula can unclog fuel injectors and give your car a new injection of power.
For top performance, drive your engine clean with Mobil Super Unleaded. High-octane at a price. Your financial picture. It's better than ever before.
But to get where you want to go, you need more than traditional banking. We're Manufacturers Hanover. We'll introduce you to a world of advanced financial services. From banking at home to personal money management, we'll help speed you toward your financial goals. Manufacturers Hanover, the financial source worldwide.
This young woman just became an owner of a major U.S. corporation. And she can't wait to get to work.
Okay, you're all set with a Cadillac.
Avis Incorporated is the only major rent-a-car company owned by its corporate employees.
A Cadillac? $45 a day? How'd you swing that?
And now the owner?
Get fast service and a Cadillac for $45 a day. Avis. Now we're trying harder than ever.
Chuck will be in goal tonight for the Washington Capitals. There are his numbers on the season. Four shutouts, a 3.06 goals against average. He has shut out the Islanders this year. Clear record against the Islanders. 1-2-1 while with Washington. And Kelly Rudy brings in a record of 21-16-5. 3.31 goals against average. And a career record of 5 wins, 10 losses, and 2 ties in games against Washington. He has faced them this season a total of 3 times. And has a record of 2 wins and a loss. Bill McCreary will be the referee. Bob Hodges and Mark Perry are the lines good. Gotcha between Gilbert and Bacala with Potvin on defense. Biddick dumping it into the Washington zone. Murphy going back for it. He and Stevens together on the Caps defense. The pass to Mike Gartner here on right wing. He dumps it out into center ice intended for Miller. Ends up in the Islander zone. Miller touching it. It'll be called back on a two-line pass.
A lot of people wonder how is it going to be for a player like Denis Potvin to play under such emotional conditions. A milestone award prior to the hockey game. Of course, the hockey game, and to be honored by the fans and the Islanders and everybody after the hockey game. And Denis Potvin, no question, he's an emotional man. He's a very young man at 34 and a half. And that's as he stood during the national anthem.
The crowd gave him the standing ovation. An emotional evening. Still has a long way to go. Langway clearing the puck for the Caps. Put it on the stick of his teammate Bob Gould, who got checked. Now Greg Adams dumps it into the center ice zone. It's recovered by Alan Kerr to Denis Potvin. Potvin dumps it in around the boards. Larchuk left it for Langway. Plays it along the boards, but not out there. Potvin with a shot wide of the Larchuk. Adams picks it up in the left wing. Fed it to Gould. Into the Islander zone. Cocked the stick for a snapshot. Then Potvin got a piece of him. Gould goes to center one that's wide of the net. And it's recovered by Alan Kerr. Shoots it in from center right. Going back is Hatcher. Bassin right on top of him. Hatcher able to move the puck out into the center right zone, but Bassin gets back. Is checked from behind. Moving down this right side is Peter Sundstrom into the Islander zone. Knocked off the puck by King. He put it right out in front. Rudy gets some help from Janssen. And the Islanders start out of their own zone, only to have the play broken up at the blue line. Now Wood gets a stick on it. Gets it King. King pass into the middle. Over near Randy Wood. Caps start again. Gustafson dumps one into the Islanders zone. Here, right back out by King. Center ice area. The Caps again force the Islanders to chase the puck. Washington dumping it in. Here's Janssen moving up left wing boards for Derek King. Out to Randy Wood. And off his stick. Recovered by Grant Ledyard. Got shot from the blue line. Rudy put the stick in front of it. Got it to LaFontaine. And Gustafson took it away from him. Dumped it back to Stevens. Stevens with a pass
for Michael Kovacka. Right side, Christian into the Islander zone, gets checked on the play. Here's Boro rounding the net. Boro and Dorton on defense. Makala with King at the moment. Fontaine there as well. And now the pass to Makala, cutting it on right wing. A backhand, he scores!
2 minutes and 5 seconds into the hockey game. The Islanders strike first. Mikko Makala, what a backhand shot. He seemed to shovel it. He took the pass in full flight. He got behind his check. Ryan Murray recognized that one of his wingers missed the check. Here's the pass by King. It was Gustafson that allowed Mikko Makala a half a step of freedom, and he took advantage by putting a backhand shot. Look at that angle. What a bad goal for Malarchuk to give up, particularly early in a hockey game, particularly any time. He was well inside the faceoff dot on a backhand shot. I could see if he went to his forehand, he'd have a little more to aim at. But Makala, beautiful shot. His 36th goal of the season, and it's a 1-0 Islander lead.
The Islanders with a broken line. They were in the middle of the player change. At the wrong time on the left side. Found some fresh legs and Makala to 1-0 lead. Jeff Dorton got the other assist.
Fourth time this season that Makala has scored against the Washington Capitals.
And here he is again, breaking in on right wing. Langway chases him to the corner. Makala slips away, comes out in front. Gilbert shoots and scores!
Are playing with a great deal of emotion. We said the crowd was emotional. The team is emotional. Makala, who has just scored a moment ago, look at the shift he puts on Rod Langway. Steps around him, brings the puck to the front of the net. There's Greg Gilbert. He puts it between the legs of Clint Malarchuk. And it's a 2-0 lead. That was only 30 seconds after the goal by Mikko Makala. Greg Gilbert, his 17th of the season, and it's 2-0. We have not played 3 minutes yet.
30 seconds apart they come. You can see the concern on the face of Washington coach Ryan Murray.
Number four, Gerald Dittick.
Dittick gets an assist along with Makala. On Gilbert's 17th of the season. Quickly, the Islanders off to a 2-0 lead over the Capitals. Coach Gary Simpson has a forward line of Pat LaFontaine, Alan Kerr, and Richie Kahm out on the ice. Murray Murphy backhanding the puck in for the Caps. Kelly Rudy plays it up the right wing to Kerr. It's bumped by Gartner, then got away from the check. Kerr plays it across to Kahm, relays it to the defenseman Conroy. Now to LaFontaine, is over the line. The pass to Conroy, and he shoots. Oh, Malarchuk just got a piece of it. Kelly Miller feeds it out to Murphy. Murphy knocked down in the center ice zone. The puck ends up in the Islander territory. This is Conroy back court. Plays it around the board, but referee Bill McCreary spotted something happening over on the far side of the ice. And we have a penalty call against the New York Islanders. Flashing penalty, break in the action. The Islanders jumping in front 2-0 very quickly.
It's time for lifestyles of the original party animal with the grand poobah of partyometry, Bud Light's own Spuds McKenzie, as he's planning tonight's big bash. His fans watch as he tans his way to party elegance. A facial and massage, and Spuds McKenzie is ready to party. Yeah! And Spuds parties with only Bud Light. He knows everything else is just alike.
Kerr in the penalty box. He was called for slashing. There's Kerr reaching out, grabbing a hold of the Washington Capitol player, pulling him down. More of a holding penalty than a slash, was it? I guess, yeah, it is called a slashing penalty. The Capitals rank 11th in the league on the power play.
They have scored 91 power play goals this season. This is their 448th opportunity. Stevens with a shot. Rudy the save, and he blocked the rebound. What a save by Rudy off Dave Christian. Caps get it back to Murphy, to Stevens, and it got away from him. He's able to hold it in at the Islander line. Gets it back of the net. Morrow there to play it around the boards. Conroy went after it, got checked. Hunter trying to dig it out of the corner. It's stolen, went right back to Murphy. Rudy kicks that aside. It ends up in the seat. Cali Rudy is playing emotional too, although he has been so hot over the last 2 weeks. Cali Rudy has a couple of milestones to reach in this hockey game. This is his 46th appearance, tying with his personal high set last year. Here's the kick save a moment ago as the puck goes up over the glass. Beautiful kick save off Murphy from the point position. Christian, what a chance to score for Dave Christian, number 27. He roams out of the picture, then he comes back in. Look at here, bang. Cali Rudy dives across, makes a couple of saves from close in off Christian. The other
thing that Cali Rudy is looking for is 22nd victory.
That would be a personal high for Cali Rudy if he was able to achieve that. 46 appearances and 22 victories.
Another look at Brian Clarence Murray. 66 games as a coach in the 81-82 season. He's been there as the head coach ever since. Caps get the draw to Stevens, to Murphy. Played it in along the boards to Gustafson. He gets checked and Vinnick is up it down the ice. The Islanders have killed off just over 40 seconds in this penalty to Alan Kerr. The 11th best Mars power play in the NHL. The Islanders penalty killing still ranked 18th. But they've killed off 29 of the last 32 penalties called against them. Still haven't been able to improve their position in the league. Christian on the right wing boards, being bothered by Trache. Christian played one back of the net. The Caps can't get it out in front as Hunter gave it to Gustafson.
After the point to Stevens.
And he gets checked by Richie Kahn. Stevens with it at center ice. The pass across to Christian on the right side. Centered one, tipped off Potvin, and he slaps it out of the air with a high stick. That gets a play stoppage and a faceoff in the Islander end of the ice.
38 seconds remaining in the power play of the Washington Capitals. The Islanders have been doing a good job. Murphy's shot from the point position, and of course Christian from close in, the two best opportunities that Washington have had so far in this man advantage. Alan Kerr with a slashing penalty at 3:12 through the first six games. The Washington Capitals, 11 power play goals on 38 opportunities. Pretty good, 28.9% efficiency on the power play against the Islanders.
Now half a minute remaining in the net advantage. They gave it to Galley at the point, dumps one into the corner. Adams plays it up the boards. This is Mike Ridley. Ridley into the faceoff circle. Adams got knocked down by Rudy. Adams loves to clog the front of the net. In fact, if you look at the Washington press guide, that's the picture they have of him standing in front of Rudy. Last year's playoff. Brent Sutter taken down in his own end of the ice. Galley moves the puck into the corner. It's underneath Brent Sutter, and there's no further play.
Penalty all but over now. Just 3 seconds remaining on Alan Kerr's slashing penalty. The puck is 30 seconds apart. Luther Makhlev at the 2:05 mark, and then right behind him, Zeb Gilbert on another move by Makhlev. He comes at the front of the net at 2:35.
And the Islanders have a 2-0 lead. Greg Gilbert is 17th.
There's Bob Gould. Have we gotten to the voting for the Selke Award? I was going to give my vote to Bob Gould. He's out there in this last 3 seconds of the power play, but they're more for a defensive role. Fontaine beats him on the faceoff, gave the puck to Potvin, around the boards to Derek King. Kerr has stepped out of the penalty box. And Ledyard at center gives it to Gould and shoots it high and deep into the Islander territory. That's Dinnick chasing it, bringing it out here on the left side. Pass across, high in the air. Kerr couldn't knock it down. Langway did, and he's iced the puck. Gerald Dinnick goes back to get it. 14 minutes and 27 seconds remaining in the opening period.
It's very big. $1,500 direct from the factory. Make your best deal on a new GL10 four-wheel drive turbo wagon. Then get a $1,500 check direct to you from the factory. Or buy a Justy for just $6,194 with Subaru's Carefree Motoring Protection Plan. And you're covered for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Just about all you pay for is gas. Now get a $1,500 check on GL10 four-wheel drive turbo wagons or Carefree Motoring Protection on a Justy. Only at your New York, New Jersey Subaru dealer.
Watching the Islanders kill off the penalty against a power play of the Washington Capitals, when you remember back to the game against Philadelphia on Tuesday, the power play of the Islanders, 2-for-6 on 9 shots. The penalty killing, they did not give up a goal. They were short 5 times. Philadelphia had but 7 shots on goal in those 5 opportunities.
Well, the Islander penalty killing has been just over 90% in the last 6 games.
Ken Morrow come back.
Now
Richie Kahn picking up a loose puck, dumps it in wide of Malarchuk. And Kahn got taken down. Play continues, and the Caps move it around the boards for Kelly Miller. Miller checked by Kahn. Turns, dumps one across the line. It's brought back by Ledyard. Laps it into the Islanders' zone. Rudy lets it go to the far corner. Miller and Kahn shoulder to shoulder, and the puck ends up back of the net. The Islanders move it up the left wing. Bringing it out is Alan Kerr. Makes it off the boards. Ledger traps it. Takes the slap shot. Now dumps it in. There's Gilbert waiting for it. Both teams in the middle of player changes, and Gilbert rushes it to center ice. Shoots it deep into the Washington zone. Murphy here in the right wing corner. Slammed into the boards by Gilbert. And Christian gets bumped by Trache. Gustafson worked it to center ice, and here's Conroy. He's stripped of the puck, and over the line on the right side is Gustafson trying to break in on Rudy, and he's checked by Janssen. Christian got to it, but could not do anything with the puck, and Gilbert moves it around the board. The Vodka centers one, cut off by Janssen. Ends up in the corner. Gustafson failed to put it in front. Conroy rounds it up, gives it to Greg Gilbert. Backhanded it to center ice. Murphy with it there. Over to Stevens. Stevens with a pass off the Vodka stick. Got it right back, and Gustafson steps in across the line, working on Morrow's quick shot blocked by Rudy. Rebound cleared wide of the Islander net. Came off Conroy. Gilbert digs it off the boards and dumps it out to center ice. Stevens has it there. Give it to Murphy. Harry Murphy shoots it in wide of the Islander net. Murphy standing on his own side of the center ice strike.
The 1988 Stanley Cup playoffs are all set to start this week, and the New York Islanders will be in the running for the 14th consecutive season. Tickets are available at the Nassau Coliseum box office or your local Ticketmaster outlets. To charge tickets by phone, call Ticketmaster at either 516-888-9000 or 212-307-7171. Islanders doing some good, clean work in their own end of the ice. That's where the offense starts. Transition point. Thomas Janssen here on Bent Gustafson. Steals the puck. Dave Christian has trouble getting to it. Islanders do. And then they clear it down into Washington's end of the ice where the faceoff just took place.
Caps fail to clear it out as Hatcher had it momentarily. King puts one in front off Kerr's stick. Morrow in after it. Knocks it away from Miller. Greg Smith moves it up the boards for the Caps. Jeff Norton lets a shot go wide of Malarchuk. Miller waiting. Here's it to center ice. Gartner able to move it to Miller. Pass to the right side for Ridley. Pulled up on Norton. Ridley reels it back to the blue line at the late penalty call as Rudy makes the save on that long shot from Smith. And now an interference penalty sets up another Washington power play. A break in the action with 11 minutes and 56 seconds left.
Hello, everybody. I'm the Hawk, Ken Harrelson.
And I'm Bobby Mercer, telling you to get ready for a Subway Series summer here on Sports Channel.
Right, Bobby, because Sports Channel has great coverage of both the Yankees and Mets. In fact, we have over half the games of New York's baseball teams. How about that? Featuring such solid swingers as Mattingly, Winfield, Hernandez, and Strawberry. So get on board for a Subway Series summer right here on Sports Channel.
Penalty, the second penalty of the game to the Islanders. Ken Morrow gets the penalty for interference. Washington back putting some pressure on the Islanders. Morrow taking out one of the forwards of Washington gets the penalty. Watch the play here by Ridley. What a good move. He lost control of the puck, gained his balance, gained the puck, and boo, it's dangerous, but it worked. When it works, it's great. When it doesn't work, look out, you're in trouble. Greg Smith took the shot. Kelly Rudy made the save.
The Islanders move the puck the length of the ice following the faceoff. Think back to the last meeting between the two teams. Caps scored on the first two power play opportunities they had in the game. Then the Islanders killed off eight in a row. They're shorthanded, and the Caps on the power play dump one in. Denny Potvin lost it to Hunter. Hunter comes out of the corner. Next his options, gave the puck to Ridley. Ridley into the faceoff circle, back to Hatcher. To Ridley. And Hatcher shot one wide of the net, bounces off the glass. And
jump ball
over the glass. No, it didn't go over the glass. Dropped into the skates of Jiggs, and he's able to clear it out. Well, that's it. I'm going to get these 5 foot changed. Hunter at the point. Into Galley. And back to the net. Gartner goes to the far side. holds the puck, wide to center one, now slips around a check, comes through in front, and Potvin went down to block it, and Vinnick clears it out.
And there's by Gardner. What a play by Kelly Rudy, holding his ground along with Denis Potvin.
25 seconds remaining in the penalty time against Ken Morrow. 2-0, the Islanders leading midway through the first period. Christian down left wing, working on Conroy as he moves in. Pulls up, the puck knocked away, Caps get to it, feed it back to Murphy, and a shot is blocked by Trotche. Norton slaps it out of there.
25 seconds now remain in the penalty to Ken Morrow.
Murphy taking the puck from Clint Malarchuk. Rounds the Caps goal, played it to the left side to Stevens, on to Christian. David Christian over center ice. Into the Islanders zone on right wing, pulls up. Centers one and right to the stick of Alan Kerr. Kerr comes to center. Norton moves up. So does Trotche as they cross the line. The pass to Norton is intercepted by Pavanta. Morrow is out of the penalty box. Here's Murphy into the Islanders zone, dumping one in deep. Eddie Morrow goes back for it. Morrow round the boards to Alan Kerr. Kerr's pass cut off at center ice. Then Trotche slams into Miller as Norton moves up for it and dumps it into the cap zone. Stevens lost it. Kerr puts it out in front. Dribbled right across the goal mouth.
Larchuk having an awful time as that puck dribbled across almost to the goal line before he saw it. He had his head and his shoulder buried. He fell awkwardly on his left shoulder.
Now the collision at center ice with Sundstrom and Potvin, and the puck ends up in the timekeeper's bench with 9 minutes and 21 seconds left in the first period.
Go back to the first goal that was scored by Mikko Mäkelä. 2:05 was a bad goal for Malarchuk to give up. Here Scott Stevens makes a big mistake. Alan Kerr takes advantage. Look where he wraps the puck right into the feet, keeps pushing. Watch his head. Look where the goaltender is. Looks like he's trying to do somersaults on a mat.
Puck dribbles wide of the goalpost. But an awkward move by Malarchuk. Here's the play a moment ago by Gardner. Look at Potvin, look at Kelly Rudy. In comes Gerald Vinnick. Front center there to help out.
Caps have dumped the puck in following the draw. Rudy plays one around the boards to left wing. Randy Wood got knocked down. Potvin and LaFontaine there together. Potvin dug it off the boards. It went to Gould and Rudy grabs it. Going wide, but Rudy made sure that it went no further. 9:04, the time remaining in the opening period. The Islanders maintaining a 2-0 lead over the Washington Capitals.
This is my hair problem. Peter, didn't you know?
What do you mean, can I see it, or was it Bora Bora?
So let's talk about you, darling. What do you think of my dress?
Ferrari, let's go to make
power. Those my Ferraris are in the shop.
The 9X Yellow Pages. Why would anyone need another?
Kelly Rudy comes up with a stop, kind of a stop. Looks good, does good. Quickly grabbing it with the catching mitt, pulling it down. Could have been wide, but you can't gamble when you're the goaltender. You're the last line of defense. The end of the first period, the second hasn't started. That game is in New Jersey. 1-1 tie, Philadelphia and Quebec. Philadelphia playing at home.
Horovo with a shot off Rudy's blocking glove right after the face-off. That puck ends up in the seats. Well, the Caps have two games after tonight. They play the Penguins at home and then go to Philadelphia to complete the season on Sunday night. Against Pittsburgh at the Cap Center this season, a win and two losses. Against the Flyers in Philadelphia, a record of 2 wins and a loss.
Another penalty call on the play, a roughing call.
Hunter, I believe, is going to get the game. He seems to be having a few words with McCurry.
Breaking the action here. It's a 2-0 Islander lead with 8:53 remaining in the first period.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
In fact, I feel like light.
Hey. What the? Oops.
I meant Bud Light.
If you want the one light that outshines them all, ask for Bud Light. Because everything else...
You all right? Sure, just a little lightheaded.
It's just a light.
The Dale Hunter gets a roughing penalty. We think it might be on Pat LaFontaine. There's LaFontaine, number 16. There's the shot by Langway. There's the roughing by Hunter on the right side of your screen. There's a Washington Capitol laying on the ice also. Isn't involved in the play, but Hunter gets the penalty.
Well, the Islanders with their first power play of this game on the season, a record of 8 power play goals and 33 chances against the Caps, ranked 7th overall. The Caps penalty killing is 5th best. See the numbers, an 81.9% efficiency rate of killing them off. Potvin and Janssen out there together. Up front, McAleev with LaFontaine and Trache. The puck cleared into the Washington zone. Langway slaps it around the boards, but off Trache, Bobby Gould brings it out. Out to Miller at center ice. Backhands one in. Janssen cuts it off. Rounds for that and starts out. Plays it back to Trache to McAleev. Down the right wing, working on Langway. Pulls up. McAleev gave it to Trache. LaFontaine back of the net. Up to Janssen. The Potvin waiting at the blue line. Right back to Janssen. Across to McAleev. Let's one go, and it sailed high and wide. Janssen waits for it. Plays it in deeper for LaFontaine. It's knocked away by Hatcher, so the Islanders have to hustle back. Rudy quickly to Janssen. To McAleev. The pass to Potvin. Breaks in across the line. Shot one off Stevens. LaFontaine the rebound, and it just went wide. LaFontaine works it to Potvin. Potvin checked at the blue line, took the man, and back for the puck comes Trache. Sundstrom moving up to forecheck for the Caps, forced that breakage. And here is Hatcher with 45 seconds left in the Islander power play as he forces them back.
One of the Islanders' hazards could be in the hockey game that in the situation they're in on the power play, they may want to feed Potvin just a little too much. He may want to take too many chances trying to get a goal here in his last regular series season appearance at the Coliseum.
Could well be. Good thought. Hiddick back for the Islanders. He and Norton together on defense. LaFontaine tipped the puck to Lauer. He's taken out on the boards by Stevens, but here's King with a drive off the goalpost. Gustafson slaps it out of there, and that's going to kill off the penalty against Hunter.
Well, Larchuk must be having trouble with his angles, particularly on the left side. That's where Nico Mäkelä beat him, well inside the goalpost from a very sharp angle with a backhand shot.
Now Miller into the Islander zone to Gartner, and Rudy robbed him. Gartner picks it up again. Right to center one. It's tipped out to center. Alan Kerr gets checked, and Ledyard takes over for the Cats. Brent Ledyard across to Larry Murphy. Back to Ledyard. It skipped off his stick and went to Norton. Norton found Kerr waiting at the blue line. He shoots one. That just raised the post. Good grief. Gartner dumps it in from center ice. 6 minutes and 20 seconds left in the opening period. Kelly Miller taken to the corner, tied up by Janssen. Gartner gets the puck, tried to center. It's knocked away from Murphy and brought up by Henry. Gail Henry for the Islanders into the cap zone, moving in on Ledyard. Pulls up, gave the puck to Kerr, back to the point. Conroy reaching for it, dumps it wide of the net. That's Ledyard chasing it. Former Ranger dumps one off the boards. It hit Basson. Bobby Basson feeds it almost to the line in time for Janssen, but it didn't work. All the Caps come over the Islander line, led by Ridley. Mike Ridley backs up, centers one. It's intercepted by Janssen. Ian Kerr moving in on Langway. Conroy trailing. Janssen right in on goal. Centers one, and it's broken up by the Caps defense. Gartner moves it to the left side for Michael Pavanka. Now to Murphy. Murphy turns his teammates in the middle of a player change. Murphy chewing up a little time. Now gets everybody into position, and Langway feeds it out to Gustafson. It went off his stick. Then Gustafson checked by McAleev. Christian back to help out. Can't get control of it. Trache did. Lost it to Gustafson. And now Christian dumps it into center ice. Caps into the Islander zone on right wing as Greg Adams taken to the boards and held there by Gilbert. Morton played it to the far side. Gustafson gets to it. Then Gustafson for the Caps. Big slap shot went wide of the net. Bounces back to Hatcher. Dumps one in away from Trache. Norton gets to the puck.
There's an
after. Puts it in front. It's tipped by Morrow, and Norton goes after it. That's it for McAleev. McAleev out to Greg Gilbert. Don't believe he made contact with it, and as Hatcher goes back, we get an icing call against the New York Islanders.
It seems every year during the 50s, New York baseball fans went wild over a Subway Series. Tomorrow at 10, you can relive those great Subway Series memories. with Sports Channel's Ed Randall and Daily News columnist Phil Pepe on New York Sports, New York Baseball 88 Subway Series. Remember, tomorrow at 10 exclusively on Sports Channel.
All tanned and healthy looking.
Baseball does that to you. Here's Kelly Rudy. Look at this. They take it from behind and let it fly. What a stop by Kelly Rudy. Had to do a little guessing, but he guessed right.
Hatcher following the face-off. Rudy out at the top of the goal crease has it in the catching glove.
Hatcher's shot. Gould deflects it. Kelly Rudy catches it. He's on target tonight, folks. He's been on target for a while now. Kelly Rudy looking for his 22nd win of the season.
Look at Terry Simpson. Mentioned him in our pregame show. I would give my second place vote in the Coach of the Year award this season to Terry Simpson. I think I would give Jean Perron of the Montreal Canadiens a look-see as well. It's been a difficult year in Montreal. Yeah.
No one knows for sure whether he's created some of the difficulty or not. And then, you know, you were a little surprised when I mentioned Terry Crisp. If that team had not done well with all of the talent, if they'd have gone into the tank a little bit, some people would say, well, he didn't do very good as a coach. But there's a lot of egos involved, and a brand-new NHL coach to have his team go to first place. Ooh, there's an Islander just got flanked by Scott Stevens, I believe.
Dale Henry is down on the deck, and now his play is called. The Islander trainer, Craig Smith, comes out to attend to Dale Henry.
Remember Bob Bassin the last time these two teams met, and it was a clean check then on Bob Bassin by Scott Stevens that time. Not looking the other way, Dale Henry. It's always a dangerous place to be not watching the defenseman when you're in front of the blue line and trying to control the puck. It appeared as though it was one of his legs he seemed to favor. He's down. He hasn't moved much as he's being talked to now by Craig Smith, the trainer. He'll be just asking him to give him an idea of where he's injured. Watch the right side of your frame here and see if you can pick up the hit by Scott Stevens. There's Dale Henry. Bang. Stevens steps in, got him up high. It looked like with his shoulder, but he may have gone knee to knee with him, or maybe it is just up in the shoulder, not just, but up in the shoulder or head area. He was jarred pretty good anytime you run into Scott Stevens. .416 remaining in the first period. It's a 2-0 Islander lead.
Lakeview Auto, Mercedes-Benz. Two reversible names that mean quality. Only Lakeview Auto of Rockville Center gives you the widest selection of new Mercedes, as only one of the largest authorized Mercedes dealers on the East Coast can give you. Only Lakeview Auto of Rockville Center offers the renowned prestige of the number one service department on the East Coast. Only Lakeview Auto of Rockville Center has the most advanced computer equipment to keep your Mercedes running smoothly. Lakeview Auto, what others offer only now. We've been practicing for years.
Dale Henry is still down. Obviously, somewhat conscious. The trainer does not want him to move, obviously, till he's sure that he's movable. Scott Stevens, it appears, has caught him. Dale Henry may have been looking to his left when he made that pass. Didn't see Stevens until it was too late. The smart thing, let him stay there until he's sure he can get up under his own power. That's what the trainers like him to do first. And Dale Henry is on his feet. He's got stunned pretty good. Watch the very right side of your screen. There's Henry, number 20. Here comes Scott Stevens. Now, he doesn't see him at that point. He passed to his left. Now he turns. He just still hasn't seen him. He was still looking left. Bang. That's a defenseman's delight. Good check. It's a clean check. Caught him in the open ice and snapped his head. Dazed him pretty good. Of course, you know, when the trainer's asking you, you're laying on the ice and the trainer's asking you, particularly when you get run over by the 637, the local, which is Scott Stevens anytime, you know, your trainer's asking you where you're hurt. You say, all over. What, are you kidding me or what? Say, are you all right? Say, what do you mean, am I all right? I wouldn't be laying here if I was all right.
Dale Henry standing at the Islander bench, leaning on the boards. His team leading 2-0 on first period goals by Mikko Mäkelä and Greg Gilbert. And we have just a little less than 4 minutes remaining in the first period. Janssen back behind his own goal, feeds it up to Gilbert. Across to Mäkelä, to Trache. Trache shot put in from the blue line, the one off Hatcher. Kevin Hatcher played it out of the reach of Gartner. Hartner reached in for it, dumped it to center, and back comes Johnson. Hunter into forecheck. Johnson's pass went to Gilbert. And broken up at center ice by Hatcher. Corvo. Ron Corvo putting it into the Islanders' zone. Johnson moved it off the boards for Nakula to Trache. Back to Johnson. To Conroy at center ice. Conroy flips it into the corner. King goes in after it with Stevens. Stevens plays it off the boards to Rachel LaFontaine. Dumped one just wide. King from back of the net. Tried to put it in front a second time. And it's broken up and cleared up by Stevens. Well, Washington is going to be called for having iced the puck, but again, they were under pressure in their own end.
Scott Stevens making a big mistake, and the Islanders have a good scoring opportunity. They did not get a shot on goal, but Pat LaFontaine tried his best to get the puck to his teammate, Dale Henry, still shaking off some of the effects of a hit by Scott Stevens. That sometimes can work in reverse. A lot of players will feel that a team is going to come out and get after them. In this case, Stevens, he may have been a little jumpy. He may have thought the Islanders were going to take a run at him, and he gave the puck away to Pat LaFontaine. Of course, a player like Scott Stevens is an honest player. It doesn't count one way or the other how big the opponent is. He hits big and small and with the same ferocity. And not too many players on the opposing team. If it's a clean check, you know, there's sometimes you just can't do anything about a clean check. It's accepted as part of the game. You don't see as many in the open ice anymore, and it's an art to be able to hit well in the open ice.
Dale Hunter had come out on a player change, but a late one, so he was set back by referee Bill McCreary. Gustafson beating LaFontaine on the faceoff. And Ledger slaps one off the boards out to center ice. Norton got to it, but they're ruling that it was knocked down with a high stick. So they'll face off just outside the Washington blue line. In fact, it's going to be closer to the center ice right now as linesman Mark Carey prepares his puck for this face-off.
Kind of an oddity, if you remember back to the last time these two teams met on March the 18th, the Islanders had 10 consecutive penalties before Hunter received one here tonight a moment ago for roughing. But the last 10 penalties were all called on the Islanders.
Norton has given the puck to Morrow, dumped it in. The Larchuk slowed it up. King after it, tried to put it in front. It was blocked. Here's LaFontaine. Back to Norton, lets one go. Larchuk down, makes the save, and the puck ends up in the seats. The Islanders have been outshot by a wide margin here in the first period, but they stung the Caps in their first two good opportunities, goals by Mikkola and Gilbert.
Jeff Norton, you'll remember the position he's in here. The pass come back from Mikkola the other night, Tuesday night. His shot went under the arm of the Philadelphia goaltender, Mark LaForest, and the Islanders won that hockey game. Jeff Norton, the winning goal, and it was his first goal of the season, first goal of his career. Islanders, that shot on goal by Norton, I should also add, was the first one that the Islanders have had in the last 7 minutes of this period. There's 2 minutes and 33 seconds remaining. The Islanders maintain a 2-0 lead.
Hunter winning the faceoff for the Caps, put the puck in the corner. Bassett and Krom in immediately. Krom kicks it back of the net. Greg Smith plays it up the boards, out into center, and down into the Islanders' zone. Coming back for it is Denis Potvin. And again, the Caps are called for having iced the puck. 2 minutes and 18 seconds remaining to play in this opening period.
The Islanders finish off their 1987-88 regular season schedule at the Coliseum tonight and head on for the playoffs next week. But it's still not too early to make your plans for next season. Call the Islanders' season's ticket office. That's the reserve seat for the 1988-89 hockey season. That's 516-794-4100. Your season's ticket is just a phone call away.
Now the Caps, following the draw, try to move it back of the net. Rick Smith dropped it off, and it's cleared out of there by Hatcher. Diddick chasing it. Diddick up the middle. Krom didn't make contact with it. It went right to Malarchuk. Lint Malarchuk, acquired by the Caps from the Quebec Nordiques. Played it around the boards. It goes to the corner off Krom. Plays it to the opposite side where it's knocked down by Bassett. Drops it back of the net. Alan Kerr is bumped by Gould. The puck goes to Hatcher and he lifts one high but right to Diddick as it came off the glass. Into Krom. That's it back of the net. There's Gould to Smith. The boards for Sundstrom. Smith bumped on the boards heavily by Bassett. They come up pushing at one another. But Diddick breaks up the Caps play at center and sends Kerr across the line. Alan Kerr gets turned around and knocked down by Hatcher. Greg Adams has given it to Greg Smith. Smith dumps it in from its own side of the center ice stripe. It didn't get to the goal line, and now Gilbert brings it out. Greg Gilbert brings it off the boards to Conroy. Goes a little further into the center ice area. Murphy gets set.
Ends up in the far side.
Conroy gives it away from him. Steve Conroy with a pass to Greg Gilbert. Off the boards to Trache as Bakula with him on right wing. Trache moving in on Murphy. What a move! Turn Murphy around and then shot it just wide. Johnson bangs it back in the net for Trache. Trache checked by Murphy. Larry Murphy moves it up to Sundstrom. Left it for Ridley. Mike Ridley dumps it in for the Caps. Rudy leaves it back in the net for Thomas Johnson. 30 seconds remaining in the opening period. Gilbert tips it out into center ice. Miller puts it right back into the Islanders zone. This capacity crowd has seen the Islanders take a quick 2-0 lead. Conroy dumping it into the center ice zone. Stevens back at the Caps blue line to Murphy. Larry Murphy steps into the Islander zone, holds the puck, now lets it go. Rudy kicks it out, the rebound there for Gartner, and it's knocked away by Conroy. Held in, Stevens with a backhander, chipped, and Rudy covers it, holds it for a faceoff with 1 second left in the period.
Backhand shot deflected directly in front of Kelly Rudy, but he was able to cover the low ice, and deflected the puck. Here's a shot stopped by Kelly Rudy. The rebound goes loose. Gardner tries to backhand it. It's deflected. Ridley tried to get it. It's deflected again, but Scott Stevens picks up the puck. Let's go with the backhand there. It's changed direction by Ridley, but Kelly Rudy was down, covering the low ice, making the stop as Malarchuk wants to get into the dressing room early and get some Gatorade. No, actually, there's 1 second on the clock, and the faceoff is in the Islanders' end of the ice. And he knows, as well as everybody else, that the Islanders cannot win the faceoff and shoot at the length of the ice and put it in before the second is up.
Well, the Caps send six men in, all of them deep. Christian, a right-hand shot, will try to beat LaFontaine and put it on the net. They have no other option but to go right to the goalie. So it's LaFontaine against Christian. Well, he gave it to Hatcher, and the shot hit Rudy up on the shoulder, and he has been hurt.
High rising shot, a hard shot by Kevin Hatcher. He's got a heavy, heavy shot that hit Kelly Rudy on the right shoulder just as the buzzer went. You can see now he is in a lot of pain. He wants to keep moving. It always seems to hurt less when you're moving around. But the Islanders head for the dressing room with a 2-0 lead.
Islanders with only 5 shots on goal in the period. Here's, it wouldn't have counted had it gone. 1 second had ticked off. Christian to Hatcher, and he got a wicked shot.
Good draw by Dave Christian, and Hatcher cannot hold up because at the point the puck reached him, the buzzer hadn't gone, so he let it fly in hope of, but it didn't work.
At the end of one, the Islanders are leading the Washington Capitals 2-0. Now let's join Lee Zeidman in our studios for a Sports Channel update.
Thanks, Jiggs. Coming up between periods, Stan Fischler standing by with an interview. We'll bring you up to date on that Devils-Penguins battle in Pittsburgh. Devils leading 1-0. Flyers are playing Quebec. The Mets and Yankees tweaked their rosters. Details coming up. Stay with us.
Whoa! People say we're nuts here at Empire Dodge making deals like this, and maybe they're right, because right now, $1,000 delivers any new or used car, truck, and stock. Here's what we have in stock right now ready to go for you. A 1984 Cadillac Eldorado, $88 delivers. An 85 Bronco, $88 delivers. A 1985 Buick Park Avenue, $88 delivers. An 84 Seville Cadillac, $88 delivers. And a 1985 Lincoln Continental, $88 delivers here at Empire Dodge. Come in and see us today. 499-0330.
Looking for a low-cost source of ready cash? The Long Island Savings Bank can help you find it right in your own home. With our Equity Power line of credit, you can borrow up to $300,000 depending on your equity, and part or all of the interest may be tax-deductible. You can use Equity Power to make home improvements, send the kids to college, buy a second home. Equity Power is the smart way to borrow from Long Island Savings Bank. Call for our super low rate now with annual caps and lifetime ceiling.
Tad Motors, the team of rebuilt engines, specializes in all domestic and foreign cars. Tad Motors' expert mechanics will replace or rebuild your car's engine using the latest machinery.
Whether it's cuttings, runs, and rotors, or a complete engine job, Tabs Motors does it all. Tabs Motors, transmission repair, front-end repair, and much more. For fast, courteous service, Tabs Motors, the professionals that are unequaled in the repair industry. Keep tabs on your car.
The goals came 30 seconds apart. The Islanders lead the Washington Capitals 2-0 at the end of the first period. You think about possibilities for the Selke Award as the best defensive forward in the National Hockey League. One of the possibilities is standing just outside the Washington dressing room with our Stan Fischler. Stan and Kelly Miller.
Kelly Miller with Stan Fischler here. Kelly, you roomed with Kenny Leiter when he went to Michigan State, and now you're playing against him. He's not in the lineup tonight. Hey, let's talk about this race. You've never been in one like it. How does it feel?
Well, it feels real good. It's a lot of fun playing hockey here at the end of the season. Usually there's some big gaps and a lot of playoff positions already taken up, and it just makes for great, exciting hockey each game.
Now, your team has been sort of an enigma. At one point, we thought you guys were going to go down the tubes, and it looked like you were going to run away with the race. And I think that right now we're seeing a Washington team that could go a long way in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Yeah, we certainly turned things around. For a while there, we were struggling like crazy. We got away from playing our system of good defensive hockey and started playing maybe a little bit too offensive, and it was hurting us. And we just got back to that, and we're playing a lot better solid hockey and more consistent hockey.
Now let me ask you this. Since you left the New York Rangers, do you feel that your game has changed in any way?
No, not really. It's the same game for me. I'm just a hard worker. I try to go out and give it 150% every night and make things happen out there. And if I'm doing that, I'm doing my job, and that's what I like to do.
You feel that you've been more fulfilled in Washington than you were at Madison Square Garden?
Well, I think that in Washington, the defensive aspect of the game, which is something I really excel at, is really harped on game in and game out, and I think maybe that's something that wasn't happening in New York. So in that sense, yes, Washington has been a big asset for me.
Okay, forgetting about your club now, if you were to pick one team that you would say would be the favorite to win the Stanley Cup in 88, which one would it be?
Well, I'd have to go with Calgary. You know, they got a great team. They put a lot of goals in the net, and they got a big team, and they seem to be rolling like crazy. So I think I'd have to go with Calgary right now, but I wouldn't count out Washington.
Okay, thanks very much. Kelly Miller of the Caps. Jiggs?
All right, Stan, in that first period, the Islanders take a 2-0 lead over the Washington Capitals, but we're outshot. Look at this. The Caps with 14 shots on goal, the Islanders with only 5. But they made them count. Mikko Mäkelä with his 36th goal of the season from Derek King and Jeff Norton at the 2:05 mark. Then 30 seconds later, Greg Gilbert gets his 17th of the season from Mäkelä and Didick, and the Islanders lead 2-0. The Islanders are 0-for-1 with the man advantage. The Capitals had 2 power play opportunities and failed to connect. 2-0, the Islanders leading the Caps in a very important Patrick Division game here at the Nassau Coliseum. When we come back, we'll take you to Lee Zeidman in our studios for another update.
Run lights here.
If you want the one light that outshines them all, ask for Bud Light.
Let me know when you're ready for another round.
Because everything else is just a light.
I picked this career because I need a challenge. My job is demanding, but rewarding. That's why I like my new Michelin Sport EPX tires. They can handle just about any demands I make on them. I rely on my tires to get me where news is happening. Great handling in any weather, when I need it.
Tonight's news was brought to you by Michelin.
Literally.
Michelin, available at Wholesale Tire Auto Centers located in Farmingdale, Hempstead, Comac, and East Meadow. Wholesale Tire and Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
The All Cutlass sale has been extended.
Folks, watch my new show, Don Cherry's This Week in Hockey. Boy, is it a hit.
Keep pace with all the NHL action. Saturday at 7 with This Week in Hockey, right here on Sports Channel.
Welcome back to our Sports Channel studios. I'm Lee Zeidman. While you're watching the fight for first place, the Devils are doing their best to climb into the playoffs, playing at Pittsburgh, down at the Igloo. First period, no score. Kirk Muller feeds Bruce Driver. He puts the puck over Steve Gannett for a 1-0 New Jersey lead. Sean Burke, who recorded his first NHL shutout against the Penguins Tuesday night, here makes the save on Dave Hunter. The Penguins haven't scored on Burke through the last four periods. Steve Gannett, though, also came up with a few big saves in the first period. The score after one, he makes a kick save on Joe Sorella. So he had only given up that one goal in the first period. But Dan Frawley, on the power play early in the second period, scores here for Pittsburgh, waiting on the doorstep for the puck. That made it 1-1. Dan Quinn scored just moments ago to make it 2-1. So the Penguins have come from behind to win. They're riding a six-game winning streak on home ice. We'll keep you posted on that one as the night progresses. The third-place Flyers are on home ice against a club that won't be in postseason play, the Quebec Nordique. It is a 3-2 game. Quebec leading in the second period. Ron Hextall's first game back from shoulder injury. Anton Stastny has his 27th goal and an assist tonight. Montreal 1-0 over Boston in the second period. The Bruins are 3-0 against the Canadiens at the Boston Garden. Claude Lemieux has his 30th goal of the season. Hartford and Buffalo are playing a 2-2 tie in the second period. Dave Tippett has his 16th. And Kerry Wilson has two assists for the Whalers. The Knicks are on the road in Milwaukee, clinging to slim playoff hopes themselves. They would very much like to get a win tonight. Bucks looking good early, though, working the inside game. Randy Brewer turns and hits the jump hook. They're going inside to Brewer tonight, and again, he works it. This time the lob pass from Paul Pressey. Ewing was nowhere to be found, and the Bucks led by six at that point. It's now a tie game in the first. Mets broke camp in Florida, shipping four top prospects back to Tidewater. Andre David, Keith Miller, Mark Carrion, and Jeff Innes will return to AAA. The Mets lost to Montreal today. Rick Aguilera takes the loss. The Mets open the season Monday afternoon in Montreal here on Sports Channel. Yankees placed Jack Clark and Neil Allen on the 21-day disabled list, and they shipped Randy Velarde and Pat Clements back to Columbus. They also beat the Atlanta Braves 3-2. Roden with his fourth exhibition victory. Guterman got the save. Tomorrow night, don't miss a Sports Channel special as we get ready for a Subway Series summer with a look back at the last Subway Series. It was 1956. Sports Channel's Ed Randall and sports columnist Phil Pepe will take your calls as we all get together to remember that Subway Series. We'll take a break, then take you back to the Coliseum.
Mogul 1 Synthetic Motor Oil. No matter what you drive, or how you drive, or where you drive, or what conditions you drive under, with Mogul Synthetic Oil Technology, there's no finer engine protection anywhere. Mogul 1, on the leading edge of Mogul motor oils.
There's something very unusual going on at Taco Bell. Something you wouldn't expect. We're making pizza. Mexican pizza. It's like pizza, but it's different. With a crispier double tortilla crust, ground beef, and two kinds of cheese. More fresh ingredients. And it's made for one person. Mexican pizza. Maybe you wouldn't expect it from an ordinary fast food place, but at Taco Bell, you would.
Hello, Taco Bell.
Islanders leading the Capitals 2-0 after the first period. Let's go back to the Coliseum. Number 18 standing by. Ed, you couldn't ask for a better start. If there's any team that you want to be in front of fast, it's Washington.
No question about it. Particularly at this time of the year, Lee, there isn't anybody you don't want to get behind to. I mean, the Islanders' emotions were running high at the beginning, the fans, the players, and it showed because the Islanders jumped out in the front 30 seconds between goals, and they have a 2-0 lead. That's how the period ended. Even though being outshot by a tremendous amount, the Islanders were able to hang on. Some good stops by Kelly Rudy in the period, obviously. He was stunned right at the end of the period. Kevin Hatcher blistered a shot right from the faceoff, and we'll show you that later. But right now, let's go to the replay of the two goals and some of the action that Kelly Rudy was faced with. Here's the Islanders starting out in their own end of the ice. Count them here. Here's the play coming out of their own end. Morrow's one pass. That's two players that have touched it. That's Jeff Norton. He's the third. to King is the fourth, and his pass to Mikko Mäkelä. Now watch what happens. Mäkelä is at a terrible angle to score a goal if you're a goaltender. He shovels it in behind Clint Belarchuk at the 2:05 mark of the first period. King and Norton assisting, along with three other Islanders, but they're not going to get credit. Only two assists on a goal. Mäkelä, his 36th goal of the season. That's the 20th time he scored against the Patrick Division. He was also partly responsible for pulling the puck out, coming to the front of the net. There, through some legs, he pulls it forward, kicks it, and in comes, yes, Greg Gilbert, pokes it between the legs of Clint Belarchuk. It's in. It's a 2-0 lead. 30 seconds after Mikko Mäkelä had scored, Greg Gilbert, his 17th of the season from Mäkelä and Didik at 2:35, and the Islanders had a 2-0 lead, and 3 minutes had not been played. Kelly Rudy was not without some anxious moments. Here, a drop pass misplayed by the Islanders. Picked up pass to who else but Mike Gardner. There isn't anybody more dangerous on the Washington Capitals. He takes it on the backhand, turns and wheels it. Kelly Rudy out, well out of his net, cutting off the angle, makes a fine stop.
Here, right at the end of the period. Now watch the puck. It never once is
touched by a stick. The linesman drops the puck. It hit the ice and bounced to Kevin Hatcher. They went fishing for it, caught nothing, but Hatcher catches it. Kelly Rudy then catches it just near the neck area, up high on the inside shoulder, and down heavily he went to the ice and hurting. He went off the ice hurting. We'll have to wait to see if the injury is going to affect. We'll be back for the start of the second period in just a moment. You're watching New York Islanders hockey right here on Sports Channel.
Hi, I'm Kelly Rudy. When you think of buying a new Buick or guaranteed used car, take my advice. Get the Tom Rice price.
Any brand new Buick, any guaranteed used car, when you get the Tom Rice price, you're getting a volume discount with all the rebates, all the incentives built right in. So for extra personal service before and after the sale, don't miss this Tom Rice special promotion. Take some good advice. Get the Tom Rice price. Tom Rice Buick in Huntington.
You know, you were right about Marsh's. What a terrific selection.
I told you. Isn't that style a little flashy for you, Dad?
Come on, don't be so conservative.
That's okay. I'll take a nice gray pinstripe any day.
So what else does this place have?
You name it, Marsh's has it. Everything from socks to sportswear.
What do you think of the old man now?
Impressive, Dad. Very impressive.
Marsh's, something for...
Hi, I'm Kelly Rudy. When you think of buying a new Buick or guaranteed used car, take my advice. Get the Tom Rice price.
Any brand new Buick, any guaranteed used car, when you get the Tom Rice price, you're getting a volume discount with all the rebates, all the incentives built right in. So for extra personal service before and after the sale,
don't miss this Tom Rice special promotion.
Take some good advice. Get the Tom Rice price. Tom Rice Buick in Huntington.
Everything from socks to sportswear.
What do you think of the old man now?
Impressive, Dad. Very impressive.
Marshy's, something for everyone.
You're just a heartbeat away from making a great deal on a 1988 Chevy at Majestic Chevrolet. Majestic is bursting with unbelievable deals, like the new Cavalier Coupe from only $67.26, or the Celebrity Sedan from only $96.44. Not enough? How about the new Sprint from only $53.99? They're here, they're hot, and Majestic's got them. All backed by Mr. Goodrange. No one knows your GM car better. No one. Remember, for great deals and the service you deserve, Majestic Chevrolet's the dealer that's all hot.
Well, there'll be a goaltending change for the Washington Capitals as you look at 30-year-old Pete Peters. He'll come on to replace Clint Belarchuk. Peters, like Belarchuk, another native of Western Canada.
A native of Edmonton, Alberta, as a Kelly Rudy
in the Islanders' net. And there are the numbers on Pete Peters. 14 wins, 11 losses, and a league-leading 2.71 goals against average. Career against the Islanders while playing for Washington is 3-5-1 in total, having played in Philadelphia, Boston, and Washington. Peters is 11-11-3. And a brief look at 27-year-old Kelly Rudy in the Islanders' net. How about this? The Devils and the Penguins, 2-2 in the second period. Pittsburgh had taken a 2-1 lead, and then Kirk Muller has the goal that tied it up. Last report we had, it was 2-1. Quebec leading Philadelphia in that game. Here it is 2-0 as the second period unfolds. Pavanka taking Stevens' pass, carrying it into the Islanders' zone. That's one goal, and it just missed on the glove side of Rudy. Wicked shot off the stick of Michael Pavanka. Giveaway, but Krejci able to clear it. Couldn't get it out. Murphy with a shot that goes off Pavanka and over the glass.
Ben Gustafson took Denis Potvin out of the play. Potvin went down heavily. The defenseman takes the shot. Washington with a pretty good start here at the beginning of the second period. Christian comes out from the side of Kelly Rudy. There's the shot. You can see the stretch by Kelly Rudy. The puck deflected before it got to him. Look at his reaction as he looks up and sees it above him, reaching up, trying to guard the top of the net as the puck sails out over the glass. 3-2 now, the Quebec Nordiques over the Philadelphia Flyers. Can you imagine? If the Flyers were to keep losing, they could go right out of the playoffs.
A lot of things to be decided here in the next few days. The collision knocking Ridley down. Conroy leaned into him. Gilbert is dragged down from behind. There'll be a penalty against the Cap.
Mike Gardner gets the penalty. Number 11. Very unlike Mike Gardner to take that. A break in the action. 2-0 lead for the Islanders. We're early in the second period.
Do you want anything?
How about a light?
Want the great taste of Bud Light? Ask for it.
Juicy, no.
No, Bud Light. Because everything else is just a light.
Mike Gardner takes the penalty. Greg Gilbert breaking down the left wing side. Gilbert pulled down by Mike Gardner. The play is... thought he went down a little easy, fought his way diligently back to his feet. Some pretty good acting by Greg Gilbert. And Mike Gardner gets the penalty.
Out of the power play, a pass of pontoon between Brad Lauer and Derek King. Langway tied up King right from the draw. The puck goes back to Norton. Now to Janssen. Janssen pulling to the left side, gives it to Norton. To Janssen, through a screen and just wide of Peters. LaFontaine tipped it in front, but off Langway, and Peters covers and holds on. King and Hatcher pushing at one another. Gail Henry just now coming from the Islander dressing room. You'll remember the hit that Stevens put on him late in the first period. He went to the bench. A little late coming back after receiving some treatment.
Pete Peters replacing Clint Malarchuk. Here's that shot off the backboard to come out the other side. The Islanders go behind to pick it off. Off Rod Langway, and Peters grabs onto it. Right from the beginning of the hockey game, Clint Malarchuk looked shaky. That goal by Mikko Makalov, in all fairness, not a goal that an NHL goaltender should give up at any time, never mind the beginning of a hockey game. The second goal by Greg Gilbert didn't have as much an opportunity to make a save. Gilbert was right on the top of the goal crease when he put it in.
The Islanders with this mad advantage after the draw. Lauer gives it to Janssen, to Brad Lauer. Off right wing, centered it in deep to King, back to Janssen. Janssen's drive, Peters the save, and it's in the side and across the goal line. Now it's being waved off. Referee Bill McCreary gives the washout signal. No goal.
Rod Langway having quite a talk now with Dale Hunter. Dale Hunter was getting out of the way when the shot came in. That's one thing defensemen do not want to see happen. Hatcher gets a penalty. Let's take a look now. Here's Hunter. He goes out to the point. There's the shot by Thomas Johnson. He didn't want any part of it. The puck is still loose. Finally, it trickles across the goal line. The Islanders raise their arms, signaling a goal. The referee says, no, no. That's not a goal. A high-sticking penalty to Kevin Hatcher. The puck touched with a high stick.
I would have to assume that's the reason it did not count. Washington Capitals said it plays on one side. It's the good news, bad news. The good news is that there it is in fact. The bad news is that Kevin Hatcher is going to the penalty box. They now have 2 men in there. A minute and 30 seconds still remain on the penalty to Mike Gardner.
And that was not
the San Diego chicken, but rather an Easter chicken, I guess, making the rounds here at the Nassau Coliseum.
Looks like the kind of chicken they used to make the soup where I last had chicken soup. A little scrawny, isn't it?
Potvin holding the puck at the right point is giving it to Trache. Trache shoots one into the pads of Peters, and he covers it. The Islanders with a two-man advantage for a minute and 30 seconds after the penalty to Hatcher. We mentioned before how they have had difficulty with two-man advantages. This is the 28th opportunity, and on the previous 27, only four times have they scored. They played with a two-man advantage for 22 minutes and 15 seconds with only four goals.
They've done well without having scored on the two-man advantage as often as they could have. Bent Gustafson, pretty good defensive player, too. Not only is he a good offensive player, but he's a very good defensive player as well. He's smart and he's good in the faceoff.
The Islanders controlling it. Pop handle to Fontaine, and it went off the heel of his stick as he tried to one-time it.
Later on, the boards to Pop handle. That's up there. Gustafson.
Gustafson down the left side. He takes a dive. Oh, my goodness. So call a penalty on Potvin.
Yes, there's no question about it. There's not a penalty there, but he's going to call it. Gustafson took a dive. I suppose that only rights the wrong by Greg Gilbert. Gilbert took a dive. Into the penalty box goes Gardner. Gustafson knows that anything that happens to a Washington Capitol with the Islanders' two-man advantage, it's going to be a penalty. Watch here. No question. It's not a penalty. It's a dive. But look at the stick of Denis Potvin. And I'll tell you where the referee is. He's away over on the other side of the ice by the Washington Capitals bench. So Gustafson, he's smart. I talked about that. He's capable offensively and defensively. Look at the stick of Potvin. He gets it up. Gustafson smartly goes down. That's a good play, believe it or not. The way things go today in this game, that's a smart play by Gustafson. He's not going anywhere anyway to the net with the puck. He hasn't got a scoring opportunity. If he falls down and there is no penalty called, he can still get up and get back into the play, so he's not taking himself out of the play by falling. So it was a good play on his part. Bad play on the referees getting caught doing it. But I suppose justification is there when you think of Greg Gilbert and his dive.
And here's Bakula breaking over the line, tipping the puck to LaFontaine. At LaFontaine to touch, he scores!
Fine moving of the puck by the Islanders as they come quickly down the ice, taking advantage of the two-man advantage. There is still a minute and 14 seconds of power play time remaining. Mäkelä looked as though he had lost the puck. Then he made a move to get it to Pat LaFontaine that succeeded. LaFontaine passes it to Trache. He one-times it, falling to the ice into the short side. And it's 3-0 now, the Islanders.
With 17:59 remaining, here's LaFontaine.
Scott Stevens, number 3. Rod Langway, number 5. Trache twisting to keep his balance. Gets the shot away, and it's a 3-0 lead. His 30th goal of the season, his 15th power play goal of the season for Brian Trache. 30 goals of the season, 8th on the all-time list, 1,281 points.
And with that point, he is tied with Alex Delvecchio. 1,281 career points. Mäkelä gets an assist on the goal. He's been in on all three Islander goals tonight. And now the teams are at 5 aside. That goal nullifying the balance of Gartner's penalty. Hatcher and Potvin in the respective penalty boxes as Ridley takes the puck, drops it back to Murphy. Larry Murphy with a shot that went high, bounces off the end boards for Kerr. Alan Kerr clears it rink wide to Conroyd. Backhanded it in around Murphy. Stevens did not go after it. Basson comes in and gets tangled up with Stevens. Here's Gartner. Mike Gartner twisting and turning. Carries it out into the center ice zone. Across the Washington line, or the Islander line, I should say. Gartner lobs one toward the net. Rudy drops it off for Janssen. Thomas Janssen starting out. Over the center ice stripe, on into the Washington zone. Pulls up, makes the pass to Basson. Lets one go. It was blocked by Stevens. Bobby Basson takes it back to the blue line, played it in along the board. Stevens with it, has given it to Murphy. Murphy into the center ice area. The pass to Stevens, coming right in on Rudy, and he's checked from behind by Norton. Still got it away, and it went high. Now Kerr challenges Stevens after he had pushed it. Norton, and referee Bill McCreary is going to call a penalty against Alan Kerr.
Flashing seems to be the signal by referee Bill McCreary. breaking through the middle, Scott Stevens. From behind, there's the chop by Alan Kerr. Good check here by Jeff Norton
as Stevens from getting a good shot away.
Kelly Rudy picks up the rolling puck, stops the play, but the penalty to Alan Kerr now has the Islanders with two men in the box. 1 second remaining on Hatcher's penalty, so Washington, with an opportunity coming up, they will have a two-man advantage. As you see the pushing going on, Kerr after Scott Stevens. Flashing is the call. He got Stevens from behind as he broke through the middle of the defense. Oh, the Washington Capitals coming up with a two-man advantage in 1 second. They have 30 seconds with a two-man advantage, providing they do not score.
On the other side of the ledger, talking about the Islander two-man advantage situation, they have given up 8 goals when they've been two-man short. Been in that position 17 times prior to this occasion. 3-0, the Islanders leading. Hatcher will come out to play the left point.
With Gary Galley on the right side of the Washington defense. Listen on the draw, put it in the corner. Conrad moves it up the board. Here's Galley. Galley beats Hatcher. Hatcher waits, passes it in a little looser. Here to Pavanka, back to Hatcher. Hatcher to Pavanka, shoots one, blocked. And off Gustafson.
Pavanka with it again. Around to Dave Christian. To the point for Galley. To Christian. Christian comes in deep. Played it to the side of the net. Rudy pokes it away. Caps hold it in. Here's Galley. Potvin is back on. Only a one-man advantage. Christian trying to center in front. It's broken up and cleared by Brent Sutter.
What a play by Brent Sutter. Beautiful read of the play. Good, smart defensive move as he intercepted the pass, which would have been a good scoring opportunity for Washington.
Now the Caps, Gustafson with a pass to Christian. Into the Islanders zone. Christian trying to go through traffic. Maintain control of the puck. Played it to the side of the net. Here's Pavanka. Potvin chases him back of the goal. Christian comes in. Centered it out in front. Brent Sutter kicks it loose. Galley gets a stick on it. Shot it right to Rudy, who makes the save. And holds on.
Gary Galley in close, but he got the puck up too high. Kelly Rudy playing the angle just right.
Takes it away.
Off his right arm as Galley made a good move coming in from the point position, but his shot was something else to be desired. Here's the move by Christian that sprung the puck. There's the play to the side of the net that Gustafson couldn't convert. Galley, number two, picking up the puck, got a shot away. Here's the play by Brent Sutter. What a great move. There's the pass. Look at Sutter as he's coming back toward the net to help the defenseman out. He intercepted the pass. Shot it down the ice.
Hand-eye coordination, body control, all the rest of it comes into play.
Yes, and just smart hockey. Actually, it's awkward for the forward in the penalty-killing position to be skating toward his own net. You know something's wrong when you see them doing that. What turned out to be wrong turned out to be right.
Rache won the face-off. Ian Crom up front for the Islanders. 40 seconds remaining in Alan Kerr's penalty. Dale Hunter to Gartner. Crom broke up the pass. Hunter gets into the Islander zone, is checked by Norton, and he's cleared the puck. Murphy moves it to Stevens. Slaps it in around the boards. Rudy cuts it off. Plays one up high off the glass, but right to the point for Ridley. Mike Ridley trying to sneak in on the right wing boards. Cranks up, shot one, blocked by Rudy. The rebound is taken away as Hunter was right there and Rudy robbed him. The Islanders have been able to clear the puck. Trache charging after it as Stevens comes back. Only 5 seconds remaining in the Caps' power play, and Stevens will start from deep in his own zone. Kerr is back on, and the crowd giving it to the Islanders, cheering wildly as they have killed off a two-man disadvantage. 3-0, the Islanders leading. 14 and a half minutes remaining in the second period. The Caps fail to get into the Islanders' zone. Diddick's pass goes to Gilbert. They move up 3-on-1. Here's Kerr over the line. And shoots Peters to save, and Stevens cleared the rebound. Bobby Gould into center ice with a pass to Corvo. Breaks it on left wing. The shot went wide of the Islander net. Recovered by Hunter, and he plays it all the way back into his own zone. Coming backward is Langway. LaFontaine into forecheck. Langway has given it to Ledyard. Now to Pavanka on left wing. Christian to the front of the net. Gould with a shot. Rudy to save, and he takes the rebound away again. And Potvin goes after the man who was in the goal crease with Rudy jabbing at him. Kelly Rudy talking to referee Bill McCreary. He's probably telling McCreary that he didn't blow the whistle. That's why Kelly Rudy would be mad. Now you see that the conversation Potvin and Bobby Gould are having.
Well, Gould has the right to try and knock the puck loose. If the whistle doesn't blow, I think that's the reason that they were mad at the referee breaking the action. 3-0 lead. The Islanders over the Capitals. 13:55 remaining in the second period.
Appreciate your helping me move. How's your back?
Thanks. As little as 10 cents.
Nothing is wrong. Can a girl just call to talk to her mom?
Love, as little as 10 cents. When calling within New York City or any of these regions, a call can make a difference. New York Telephone.
Yvonne Corriveau, number 26, was the recipient of some of the onslaught of Denis Potvin. I'm not so sure about Kelly Rudy. The Islanders break out quickly. Look at the smart move here by Scott Stevens. He didn't go after him because he couldn't. It was a 3-on-1. Forced Alan Kerr, who was having trouble with a rolling and bouncing puck, let him shoot it at Pete Peters. Let him cut down the angle, and back come the Washington Capitals. They cross the blue line. There's the shot. It's wide. Coming off the backboards, Hunter picks it up and puts it in front of the net. That's where all the mayhem started from.
Corriveau seemed to be shaken up as he went back to the Washington bench with the trainer. Oh, my! Rudy just made a dazzling save off Dale Hunter. The Islanders move it out to center ice. Langway dumps it in across the line, and that's offside. Some pushing and shoving after the whistle. Now Hunter goes after Conroy. And they call a meeting over on the far side of the ice. Hatcher poking his fist into the face of Mikko Mäkelä. Now Gartner comes in. Islander teammate pulling Mäkelä away as Hatcher has a penalty. There may be others, as this isn't over. Linesman Bob Hodges waltzing Hatcher around as he wanted to get back into the play. 13 minutes, 37 seconds, the time remaining here in the second period as you see Hatcher going to the penalty box.
One of the shortcomings that the Washington Capitals have had over the years is the one, short temper, and two, they do not... A break in the action, 3-0. The Islanders lead the Capitals, 13:37 remaining here in the second period.
When it comes to autofocus cameras, some give you part of the action, but Canon EOS gives you all of the action. When it's so dark that some can't focus, EOS doesn't miss a trick. And Canon EOS has computers and motors in every lens for fast focus. So great shots are easy and so creative, the competition is out of the picture. EOS, more than autofocus, easier than ever. Canon, the official camera of the New York Islanders.
Kevin Hatcher has a penalty, a roughing penalty. He's in the box. He threw a couple of left hooks at Mikko Mäkelä. Kelly Rudy comes up big again, as he did in the first period. He's continued here in the second. As they move the puck, Adams passes it in front. Backhand shot by Hunter. Look at the stop by Kelly Rudy. Hunter swinging at the bouncing puck. Hit Kelly Rudy right in the middle of the chest with the stick. Didn't hurt. Kelly probably doesn't know he did it.
Washington, a man short. Stevens has put the puck in the Islander zone. It's picked up by Derek King. King waiting back of the net as Miller is forechecking. King to Diddick to LaFontaine. He's over center, on into the Washington zone, trying to go in around Stevens. He got hacked at. LaFontaine plays it to King. Puts it high and to the side of the net where Peters knocked it down. Stevens with it. Bauer backed into him. Langway moves the puck up, and out comes Kelly Miller. Miller and Gould into the Islander zone. Miller shot off Potvin's stick and way up into the seat.
Washington like to go to the attack. Minute and 23 seconds remaining on Hatcher's roughing penalty. They've scored or 8 shorthanded goals, the Washington Capitals, which is a long way from league leading, but take a look as a couple of plays ago, there's the shot by Gould. What a stop by Kelly Rudy. That was Denis Potvin as he went after. Ooh, look at the stab by Kelly Rudy, too. He took the point of the stick and jabbed it at Corriveau. So Corriveau takes it from Kelly Rudy and also from Denis Potvin.
Trache lining up against Gustafson for this faceoff. Lines defenseman Mark Perry backing Gustafson up, drops the puck, and again it bounces strangely and comes outside the line as Stevens plays it out.
Some of the action we've seen, Kelly Rudy making saves. He's now had 57 consecutive shots by the Washington Capitals that he stopped. Going back to the last game, 35 in Washington, 21 so far tonight. So he's been a busy boy, but he hasn't given any ground.
You know, they work out the save percentage. I like to do it the other way, and how many shots it takes to get a goal. And it works out against Kelly Rudy, 9.8, and with Bill Smith, 9.5. There isn't much to argue about there, is it?
Not at all. The rank, what, third now in the league in the tandem of goaltenders?
Mm-hmm. Both Bill Smith and Kelly Rudy would be quick to tell you that's a reflection also on the defense and the forwards. It's a team-type statistic. You know, they take a lot of personal pride in it. Puck played around the boards, but not out. Janssen tried to move it in. It hit Gustafson, and he's been able to clear it down the ice. 43 seconds left in Hatcher's roughing penalty. Rudy. Back of the net. Janssen puts it in the corner. The puck picked up by Trache. Jeff Norton. Now to Janssen. The Islanders with a 3-0 lead, and there are a lot of people that'll tell you that's the worst lead to have in all of hockey. Well, we'll watch. Trache across the line. Got it to Janssen. Winds up, shoots, just went wide. Norton can't get to it over on the far wing. Slides harmlessly all the way into the Islanders' zone.
Of course, I would sooner have a 3-0 lead than a 2-0 lead.
Yeah, I suppose.
Or how about a 4?
Here's Basson trying to make it for it to LaFontaine, and he does! Power play goal for Pat LaFontaine, 4-0.
You could see it coming. The Islanders were actually changing on the fly. They caught the Washington Capitals a little lackadaisical. Brian Murray is really upset. What do you have to do with these guys, he's wondering. I change goaltenders when it's 2-0. It's now 4-0, and I've used up both my goaltenders. What a play here by Bob Basson. Here the Islanders dart through the middle of the ice. Basson looks like he's going to be checked. Caught by Scott Stevens. But guess what, boys? Don't leave your seats. I've got a pass in mind to Pat LaFontaine. His 47th goal of the season. His fifth against the Capitals this year on a beautiful play by Bob Basson. Pat LaFontaine, his 15th power play goal of the season. There were 3 seconds remaining on the power play when LaFontaine made it 4-0.
Johnson gets an assist along with Bob Basson, so it's 4-0. And we still have not reached the midway point of the second period. Kelly Miller in forechecking. Johnson takes him to the corner boards. Alan Kerr unable to move it out. Here's Gartner, big slap shot. Rudy got a piece of it, and the puck goes over the glass and on into the seats. Off the catching glove of Kelly Rudy. See the sweatband hanging down his back tonight.
It looks like he's got a pigtail. Thomas Johnson with his 300th career point on the goal by Pat LaFontaine. Here's the shot by Mike Gardner. Fans getting a kick out of the Patrick Division standings being shown here in the Mystics board. There you are. 86 points, the Islanders, 84 the Capitals. The Flyers, who were losing to Quebec 3-2 at last report. 21-10, the shots on goal so far in this hockey game in favor of the Washington Capitals, but they're losing 4-0.
Faceoff coming in the circle to the right of Kelly Rudy. Brent Sutter winning the draw from Ridley has given it to Conroy. Around the corner boards. Johnson with it now. On to Brent Sutter. Dumps it in to the right of Pete Peters. Comes off the end boards for Mike Gartner. Gartner flips it high in the air into center ice. Ridley catches up to it. Ridley ridden off the puck by Conroy. Miller. Now Kerr brings it out. Alan Kerr over center ice. On to Brent Sutter on the right side. Sutter's shot hit Greg Smith. Smith plays it around the boards. Right to Kerr. Fires one. It's blocked in front of the net. Smith standing in front of Brent Sutter. And now Gartner moves it to Miller at center. Miller back to right wing, intended for Gartner. He goes back to the neutral. And Kerr is going off. Washington with another power play opportunity. 10.5 minutes the time remaining in this second period. The Islanders scored twice in the first. Two more here in the second. And they have taken a 4-0 lead over the Washington Capitals.
This bud's for all that you do.
Papers say you busted it up pretty good. This is where we start.
You got come on. A long road back. You missed the no. Cheers. No. Can't beat on, those doubts and fears. You
ready? Wait up.
For that something that won't let us quit, the clean, crisp taste of Beechwood-aged Budweiser.
To your first game back.
This Bud's for you.
Alan Kerr, his third penalty of the hockey game, an interference penalty there as he hooks up the Washington Capitol forward, pulling him to the ice. Mike Gardner's down. Kerr is off. So Washington trailing 4-0 halfway through the hockey game. Get another power play.
And with the man advantage, they feed the puck to Hatcher, to Stevens. Lets one go. Right on. It came off the stick, and Rudy covers it. Now some scuffling in front of the net. Adams and Jiddick pushed at one another and then back away as the linesman
right in different directions. From the faceoff, Washington win the draw. Hard shot by Scott Stevens, who was deflected. Kelly Rudy down again making the save. He's down covering. There it is, deflected between the legs of Denis Potvin, but Kelly Rudy had his left pad on it. Diddick shoves Adams and then pops him one. Got away with that one.
A lot of other games around the league tonight. Here's an update.
Aha. Devils maintain a one-goal lead. They fell behind 2-1 at one point.
See, the Flyers have come back for a 3-3 tie. And here it's 4-0. The Islanders in front of the Caps as Hatcher comes in off the right point, shoots one, hit the side of the net, and then the rebound is golfed wide. Stevens with it on the left side. Lays it away from Christian, got it to Hatcher, his shot through a screen is tipped. Christian takes it back of the net. Off the boards, Gustafson feeds Hatcher from the blue line. Rudy got a piece of that, it goes to Stevens. Stevens backing up to the point. Adams standing in front of Rudy, screening. Bothering him all the way. Hatcher with a pass to Stevens. Stevens plays it in deeper for Christian. He can't get it to Adams, and the Islanders snap it off the boards and down the ice.
Brent Sutter again being the patient penalty killer. Gets his stick on the puck. Ken Morrow shoots it down as he has done again there.
Stevens could not get it into the Islanders' zone. We watch Peters handling it back of the net. Hatcher picks it up. Plays it across to Gartner. Didn't seem to be anticipating it. There's a delayed penalty call in effect. And now handed out, and the Islanders are going to be two men short.
43 seconds remaining on Kerr's penalty. It must have been too many men on the ice. We'll have to wait for the referee, McCreary. He was standing right at the Islander bench.
A bench minor for too many men on the ice.
Too many men on the ice is the announcement.
47.
So for the second time in the hockey game, the Capitals still have a two-man advantage. It's the third time in the hockey game the situation has arisen. The Islanders had a two-man advantage. Watch to the right of your screen as the Islanders scrambling to change. There's the referee with his arm in the air. The Islanders with too many men. They were a man short. Somebody missed an assignment.
Serving the minor penalty for the Islanders.
Interesting to point out that when Clint Malarchuk, was in the nets at the beginning of the hockey game, the Islanders scored two goals on him in five shots. And Pete Peters replaced him at the beginning of the second period. The Islanders scored two goals also on five shots.
There is Clint Malarchuk and now Pete Peters. Two-man advantage for 43 seconds for the Washington Capitals. The Islanders will have a third goaltender here by the first of the week. The Oshawa Generals were eliminated last night. That's for the Caps, and a rink-wide pass to Gartner went astray. Dale Hunter, falls with nobody near him. Right back to the right point. Murphy to Stevens. Stevens winds up, shoots off Rudy's pad, off his skate perhaps, and then cleared down the ice.
That deflected off Denis Potvin first, then it deflected off Kelly Rudy. I don't think he saw it, but he had himself in the right place, which is the biggest part of it all.
Here's Murphy with a pass across. Hunter centers, and it's banged in. The Capitals get on the board with the power play. The two-man advantage works, and it is 4-1.
9 seconds were still remaining in the first period, so they're still on a power play for a minute and 26 seconds. One goal now for the Washington Capitals. Scott Stevens led the play. There's his pass. Murphy, the other defenseman, lays it out to Hunter. Hunter takes a shot. It was deflected there. Then it was reassured, I believe, yes. Not Steve Evans. Continued on with the play. I wasn't sure whether or not Mike Gardner standing to the side. There's Stevens. I believe the puck's already in as Gardner taps it. But Scott Stevens, who led the rush, finished the play off. A timeout has been called. Scott Stevens. His goal makes it now 4-1, his 12th goal of the season.
Larry Murphy.
And a timeout. And obviously the timeout call here by Brian Murray is to give the power play unit that he has on the ice right now that has just scored an opportunity for a quick breather. They would love nothing better than to close the gap by two. They're still on a power play.
I mentioned a moment ago that the Islanders will have another goaltender in camp. That'll be Jeff Hackett, who played in Oshawa. The Oshawa Generals had a 3-0 lead in games over the Ottawa 67. Canada assistant coach Brian Kilray, who was in charge in Ottawa, had his team come back and last night completed a sweep with a 5-0 shutout of Oshawa.
Imagine that, being down 3 games, come back and win it 4 straight.
They had no reflection of that at all on the goaltending of Jeff Hackett.
Or the coaching of Kilray?
Well, maybe.
We'll have to tease him about that.
Morrow knocking away the shot of Hunter's. The Caps continue with a mad advantage. Murphy over at the right point. Back to Stevens, and it jumps over his stick. Stevens puts it into the Islanders' zone and the delayed offside, and the Islanders able to clear it out. Now 55 seconds remaining in the penalty. The one called for having too many men on the ice. Christian with a pass to Murphy over center. Adam seemed to step in front of him, forcing Murphy to dump it in. Gustafson in after it, up by Brent Sutter. Monroe digs it off the boards and shoots it down the ice. 33 seconds remaining in this Washington power play as Stevens takes it from Tudor, sends it to Gustafson. Tom chasing Gustafson, the pass to Murphy, bothered by Brent Sutter, comes back to Murphy, a slap shot off Brom's stick. That goes over the glass.
The Islanders are everywhere. They're everywhere. That time Richard Crom, who has not seen a lot of ice time, gets in front of that shot. The shot by Larry Murphy and deflects it up into the seats. A couple of good shifts for Scott Stevens. Take a look at the out-of-town now. Quebec has regained the lead. Michel Goulet has scored in the third period. Quebec leading Philadelphia at the Spectrum in Philadelphia, 4-3. I think Philadelphia has lost 14 games at home this season, which is very unusual for them. The most they've lost 14 since the 69-70 season.
Ledyard off the right point. Rudy got just a chunk of that. It comes back to Hatcher. Ledyard plays it across, entered in front, and tipped but not out. Ledyard with a drive that missed the net. Hatcher gets to it again. Into Ridley. Back to Hatcher. Ridley in the pass tipped away by Trache. Potvin and Miller go to the boards and both end up on the deck. Puck is underneath Miller. And there is no further play. They'll face off with 7 minutes and 4 seconds remaining in the second period, and the team's back at 6-6.
There's his big tail, Kelly Rudy's big tail. Kelly Rocky Rudy. Here's that stop a moment ago. He just got a piece of it. It whistled just an inch by the goalpost. Got enough of it, though. That's all that counts. Just a statistic now. Washington Capitals, 6 shots on the last 2 power plays. They had 2 while they were a 2-man advantage. There's the action in front of the net. You see Kelly Miller cross in front of Kelly Rudy, trying to set up a screen or deflect the puck, either or.
Reminder that following the game tonight, there will be some retirement ceremonies for Denis Potvin, and we will carry them right here on Sports Channel, the color of the ball, following this game between the Islanders and the Caps. Conroy dumping the puck into the Washington zone. Peters gives it to Langway. Moves it around the boards to Gould. Gould lays it ahead to Pavlanka. Korovo. Conroy going in after it. Lays it around the boards to Greg Gilbert. Gilbert finds an opening. Dumps it down the ice, and Gilbert gets challenged and whacked at from behind by Korovo. The whistle is for icing against the New York Islanders. We have 6.5 minutes remaining as Gilbert goes hunting for Korovo. Take a break here. The Islanders in front, 4-1.
Make your best deal on a new GL10 four-wheel drive turbo wagon. Then get a $1,500 check direct to you from the factory. Or buy a Justy for just $61.94 with Subaru's Carefree Motoring Protection Plan. And you're covered for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Just about all you pay for is gas. Now get a $1,500 check on GL10 four-wheel drive turbo wagons or Carefree Motoring Protection on a Justy. Only at your New York, New Jersey Subaru dealer.
Ready for a face-off in the Islander end of the ice. Look at this, the total shots on goal thus far by the Caps 27, by the Islanders 10. The Islanders are leading 4-1.
Figure that you're being outshot almost 3-1, and you're outscoring the team 4-1. How do you make sense out of that?
You hear the crowd reacting to the scores that we just posted a few moments ago. The Devils leading and the Nordiques leading. Capacity crowd appears to be enjoying that. We'll get you up to date at the end of the second period. Lee Zeidman will be in our studio. The Islanders again have been charged with icing the puck.
Saturday at 1:30, the Islanders face off with the Devils in a key Patrick Division matchup, and Sports Channel gives you the viewer's choice for the team of announcers you'd prefer to listen to. You can follow the action with myself and Jiggs McDonald on Sports Channel, or the Devils team of Peter McNabb and Gary Thorne on Sports Channel Plus. It's your choice either way. Just don't miss all the action when the Devils collide with the Islanders live Saturday afternoon at 1:30 on Sports Channel and Sports Channel Plus. Sports Channel Plus is not available in all areas.
I guess we know who those folks will be listening to, huh? Puck at the side of the...
With myself and Jiggs McDonald on Sports Channel, or the Devils team of Peter McNabb and Gary Thorne on Sports Channel Plus. It's your choice either way. Just don't miss all the action when the Devils collide with the Islanders live Saturday afternoon at 1:30 on Sports Channel and Sports Channel Plus. Sports Channel Plus is not available in all areas.
I guess you know who this is. Puck at the side of the Islander net, cleared away by Rudy. LaFontaine moves it up the boards. Randy Wood couldn't clear it out. LaFontaine has golfed it out to center, and it's picked up by Greg Gilbert. Gilbert trying to get around. Hatcher got a chunk of it. The puck comes back to Janssen, moves in around Langway. Janssen can't get a shot away as he collided with Corvo, and the cap breakout. Lavaca into the Islander zone, drops it back. Here's Gould moving in on goal, and he scores! Bobby Gould has cut the margin to 4-2.
The Islanders were facing a 3-on-1 attack. Then Greg Gilbert got up into the play, and it was a 3-on-2, but Bobby Gould, with a beautiful move, walked in and beat Kelly Rudy to his left side. His 12th goal of the season.
As Bob Gould, here's the play here. Thomas Johnson beat one player too many,
and then suffered the consequences as Pavanka breaks away. There's Gould on his right. They have another player to the left. There he is, number 26, Yvonne Corvo. Look at the move here by Gould, a beauty. Kelly Rudy stretches out with his left hand and his left pad, but he doesn't stretch far enough. It's now a 4-2 hockey game with 5:45 remaining in the second period.
Scored by number 23, Yvonne Gould.
Assen up with Kerr and King for the Islanders. Morrow and Norton together on defense. Murphy and Stevens back for Washington.
Gould, 12th of the year from Pavanka.
Pass to Sundstrom. He's given it to Gartner into the Islanders' zone. Gartner got one into the skates of Norton. Norton around the boards to Alan Kerr. Wells drink wide with a feed. Bassett across the line working on Murphy. Tried to drop it back. Kerr goes after it. To the point for Norton into Kerr. One time said it, he missed the target. Comes off the left wing boards for the Caps. Sundstrom is bumped by Morrow and taken off the puck. Bassett looking for it at the blue line. Knocks Gartner flying. Alan Kerr moves it rink wide, and here's Jeff Norton into the center ice zone. Gave it to King, and little trouble handling it. Now to Kerr, he's checked at the blue line by Sundstrom, up to Hunter. Hunter on left wing, shoots, bad save, as Rudy was well up, cutting down the angle. And Morrow with the pass around to Norton, out into center ice, put it on Bassin's stick. He's over the line with King. Kerr trailing, picks it up, shoots, Peters the save, he's way out, covers it, and holds on. Again, some pushing and shoving after the whistle. 4 minutes and 39 seconds. All that's remaining. Smith and Bassett exchanging some greetings. Referee Bill McCreary wig-wagging.
indicating that there will be a penalty or two.
Temper is starting to flare a little bit. Kelly Rudy comes up with another fine stop. 30 shots on goal now by the Washington Capitals. Peter Sundstrom with his pass to Hunter. Dale Hunter rips one. Kelly Rudy, there's calling the angles perfectly, or playing them, I should say. Kelly Rudy easily plays it off his left pad. Back come the Islanders. There's the drop pass. Alan Kerr's shot deflected off the mask of Pete Peters. He grabs a hold of the rebound, and here comes Kerr slamming into Greg Smith, who then pushes at Bob Basson, who shoves back, and Smith and Bob Basson each getting 2 minutes for roughing. A lot of tempo in the hockey game still.
You see Trache squaring for the faceoff with Gustafson. Trache got the draw. Gilbert has given it to Diddick. From the blue line, pad save. Trache kicking at it. Catching a stick away from Gustafson, and there'll be a penalty. Ed Gustafson for holding.
Ryan Trache tried to kick the puck into the net. He didn't have a stick to do it. 4-2 now. The Islanders still lead the Capitals. 4:30 remaining in the second.
I give up, Brian.
Listen, Rick, hockey players are a lot like the vehicles of Van Buren GMC.
You mean tough, durable, and stylish?
Right. So when you're skating, think of the smooth ride vehicles from Van Buren provide on any surface. And when you're shooting, be confident, like Mr. Goodwrench, because no one knows your GM truck better, no one. Then put it all together while remembering anything cars can do, Van Buren can do better.
Nice shot, Rick.
Thanks, Brian.
Ben Gustafson gets the penalty for holding Brian Trache's stick. Trache kicked at the puck. Here's Diddick's shot, stopped by Peters. There's the kick by Brian Trache. Gustafson has a hold of his stick. Trache can't get it loose. Gustafson held on too long, and the Islanders have a power play.
Denis Potvin with a pass to Trache here at the right side. To Janssen, to Trache. In deeper to McAvoy.
It's the full line. Janssen has been going. He's gone! Puck took a mean hop. Thomas Johnson drilled it from the right point position. The puck was low. It was either deflected or it hit something on the ice. Probably a deflection. It skipped up into the top of the net.
The Islanders regain a 3-goal lead. They were being threatened. The penalty to Gustafson, a big one, in favor of the Islanders. Thomas Johnson in the corner to Mäkelä. Mäkelä with the return pass. Here's the shot by Thomas Johnson. Comes in low. Here it comes. Boom. Hit somebody. It hit Hatcher, I believe, and deflected by the goaltender, Pete Peters. Here's the shot by Thomas Johnson. It's off Kevin Hatcher. He got a piece of it, but he didn't get enough of it. And it's a 5-2 hockey game. The Islanders are ahead.
Peters, who has given up an average of 2.7 goals per game, is blitzed with three by the Islanders here in the second period after coming on to replace Clint Malarchuk.
Long time between shots again for the Islanders, but they're making them count. Just prior to the goal by Thomas Johnson, the Islanders' first shot, remember the one that went off Peter's mask, since the goal they scored, 7 minutes and 1 second to go. So it was almost 8 minutes between shots. They had two shots and two goals in just about 8 minutes.
See the Washington bench. Murray brothers, Brian the head coach, 45 years of age. His younger brother Terry, a former NHL defenseman, is the assistant coach.
And number 19, Brian Trache.
Trache and Mäkelä assisting on Thomas Johnson's sixth goal of the season. That's his first power play goal this year.
Power play goal at 15:46. Itself is unusual when you consider the shot that Johnson possesses. Randy Wood out with Pat LaFontaine and Richie Crom for the Islanders. Knocked up against the boards is Brent Ledyard. And the puck over on left wing, controlled by Rich Crom, with a pass out to center ice for Randy Wood. Three taps get back as Wood comes over the line. Chased wide by Stevens. Skips away from him as he rounds the net. Wood pushes it back. Morton broke his stick on the shot, I believe. LaFontaine taken down back of the net, and here's Stevens with the pass off Pavanka and out into center ice. Morton waits, and now dumps it in. 3 minutes, 10 seconds, all that's left in the second period. 5-2, Islander lead over the Washington Capitals. Denis Potvin playing his last regular season home game. Lugs the puck into the Washington zone. He's given it to Makula. The pass just missed Krejci. Comes back to Gilbert. Greg Gilbert dumps one in around the boards. Scott Stevens clears it out for Washington, giving it to Mike Ridley into the Islanders zone. Ridley, a drop pass to Murphy. Krejci bumps him, knocks him down. Murphy puts it on the stick of Potvin. Up to Gilbert. Chases it into the Washington zone and shoots one. Peters the save. Adams takes it and plays it behind the net for Murphy. Larry Murphy flips one high. That goes up into the seats with 2 minutes and 27 seconds left in the second period.
Monday afternoon at 3, the Subway Series Summer on Sports Channel begins when the Mets open up their 1988 season against the Montreal Expos. Then Tuesday afternoon at 1, the Yankees start their drive for the pennant when they slug it out with the defending world champion Minnesota Twins. It's a Subway Series Summer with season-long coverage of the New York Mets and Yankees right here on Sports Channel.
During our second intermission tonight, our Stan Fischler, who is celebrating a birthday today, will have as his guest Mrs. Denis Potvin. Valerie will be guesting with Stan. You look at Mike Ridley getting ready for a face-off. The referee and the linesman, Bob Hodges, conferring off to the side of the Washington net. Hodges spent a lot of time down in the Islanders' zone. A broken stick seemed to be the problem. Kelly Rudy had rescued it, put it in his goal. Hodges said, you can't do that. Pushed it off into the corner, but that's a while back. Alan Kerr moving it around the boards in the Washington end of the ice. Basson leans into Murphy. Murphy spins away from the checking, lays it up to Gartner, to Ridley, but it's knocked loose by Conroy. Then Basson leans into Ridley and sent him flying. Gary Galley bumped off the puck by Jerry King of the Islanders. Steve Conroy is back. Couldn't clear it out. Now Ridley gets checked at the blue line. Alan Kerr plays it down into the Washington zone, and Murphy is back. The Islanders came into the game with a two-point lead over the Washington Capitals atop the Patrick Division, and are leading this one 5-2, trying to extend that lead to 4 points. It would not be enough to clinch first place, but it would get them to within a point of finishing first for the sixth time since the Patrick Division was created. The Islanders have just iced the puck. Play stoppage with a minute and 24 seconds remaining in the period.
The Islanders would need just a tie in either the Meadowlands against the New Jersey Devils or with the Boston Bruins to guarantee first place if they win this game tonight. Think of the scenarios. There's all kinds of them going on here. You can play it if, and if all night long. There's some of the banners of the Islanders, the Patrick Division champions.
Five times they have won the division, dating back to 1977-78, again the following year, 80-81, 81-82, again in 83-84. It was that season, 83-84, that the Islanders were defeated by the Edmonton Oilers in their bid to win five consecutive Stanley Cups. Denis Potvin told us earlier this season in an Islander pregame show that that's one of the bitter memories that he has.
You know, in contrast to that, when we talked to Wayne Gretzky, I had him on when the Edmonton Oilers were here. There's a hard shot by Langway from the point position. Kelly Rudy was somehow able to get in front of it. Gretzky said the bitterest moment for him was when they lost four straight to the Islanders the first year that they won.
Mm-hmm.
Or the second, I said, first time they beat Edmonton in the finals.
Yeah, that did not sit well with the Oilers. Norton chasing it back into his own zone, takes it away from Corriveau with less than a minute to go in the period. Norton, Randy Wood. Wood into the Washington zone, tried to cut in on Langway, did, and Peters made the glove save on that shot. Here's Corriveau. Shot it into the Islanders zone, Potvin knocked it down and just played it into the Washington zone, wide of Peters. Peters playing it at the side of the net, avoids any icing call, and now comes Corriveau with a pass to Sundstrom. Sundstrom at center ice. Got it into the Islander zone. Rudy leaves it, poked it into the corner. It's picked up by Potvin. Up the wing to Makula. And at least three assists here tonight as the Islanders lead 5-2. Pavanka winds up, shoots Rudy to save. There's absolutely no rebound.
Good coverage by the Islander defenseman. Good coverage by the goaltender, Kelly Rudy.
31 shots on goal through two periods so far. Kelly Rudy has handled all but two of them. There's the shot by Pavonka. He had time. Kelly Rudy again playing his position perfectly on the angle. He gets that low shot by Pavonka. Look at here, from point blank range, but finally an Islander reaches out with the stick and puts it across his arms. That killed some of the sting of the shot. Kelly Rudy hangs on and stops the play. 4 points tonight for Mikko Mäkelä. That's the first time this season that Mäkelä has amassed that many points in a hockey game. He's had 21 games where he's had 2 points, somewhere around 14 games where he's had 3 points. But he's never had four until tonight, and he's not finished yet.
15 seconds remaining in the third period. Ben Sutter and Gustafson to face off from the Islander end of the ice.
See the face off from behind the Islander goal, our low ice level camera. And Sutter winning the draw, puis it in the corner for Potvin to Trottier. Trottier to Brent Sutter. Banks it off the right wing boards and down the ice. Matt Ledyard backs in. That's going to do it for the second period. The Islanders outscore the Caps 3-2 in the second period. Kelly Rudy making some sensational saves. Have a look at Islander coach Terry Simpson, and now goaltender Kelly Rudy as he gives something to referee Bill McCreary. Certainly wasn't a love note. But at the end of two periods, the Islanders being outshot, but leading by three. It's New York Islanders 5 and the Washington Capitals 2. Now let's join Lee Zeidman in our studios for a Sports Channel update.
Thanks, Jake. Coming up between periods, we'll get you up to date on that Patrick Division playoff race. The Devils, the Penguins in Pittsburgh, Philadelphia on the ice with Quebec. Highlights and scores ahead after we break. Stan's got an interview ahead, so don't go away.
Introducing the G-Shock 5200 watch. The watch from Casio. The sports watch that's ready for action with a built-in shock absorber.
Then, waiting for the festivities to start, the final score, the New York Islanders 7, Washington Capitals 8. The shots on goal in the third period by the Capitals 8. By the Islanders, 4. Look, a shot to goal. 38 for Washington, 18 for New York. 5-2. And the second period, now the current score is Ben Pennington for the season. Much more than a first goal. 5-4. Pennington for the first goal. 8-0-6. And the first goal was Derek King from Kerr at 11:44. That rounded out the score at 7-3. The Budweiser play of the game. Take a look at it. We're in trouble. Guess what? In the third period, one out puck in front of the net. Who clears it? There's Denis Potvin, the defenseman. In third and first. One game. In the box. Budweiser. The
extraordinary effort every way around, from goaltending, defense, on out to the shooters.
Kind of a honest moment.
It would have been possible for me or my teammates. But I'm proud to say that in leaving behind all of you, I feel quite comfortable in the hands of my wife and my family, who now will be my new supporting cast in a world that I'm not too sure about. I'm sure that I'll see you at some point or another.
Thank you so much for your help. You've been great.
And Denny coming up behind you. Another one that needs it. It's Michael Bossy.
Thank you.
after, and I thought it was tasteful, I thought it was classy, and I thought that Denis Potvin articulated his position so well, just the way he articulated the game of hockey. He's now doing a tour of the rink, and the fans are giving him what he so richly deserves, and that is just an enthusiastic round of applause. And he's not missing anybody in the rink. It's as if he'd like to get into the act with him. Now waving, trying to include every corner of Nassau Coliseum. He just went right through it, came from the bottom of his heart. Now he's coming back to teammates. Denis now going up and down the matting. His wife is still out there, Valerie. Teammate, former teammate, Bobby Nystrom, now his assistant coach. By the way, I thought Jiggs McDonald, MC, excellent show, which is no surprise. Then he's making his way toward the dressing room with his wife, Valerie. Michael Bossy there. And as they take off, it was a magnificent night. So once again, the final score, Isle 7, Capitals 3. Remember, Saturday afternoon at 1:30, it's the viewer's choice when the Islanders square off with the Devils in a Patrick.